Welcome to the STABcast, a podcast dedicated to Star Wars Legion.
We are the
Welcome, cadets and commanders, to the STABcast, the Sunsphere Tactical Attack Brigade's Star Wars Legion podcast. I'm Ben, Scott and Deformed Fowler, joined by Ryan, Never Satisfied Slawoski, Will Geonosian Noises Heim, and Tim Commitment Issues Hannon has decided to be on this podcast tonight.
You're welcome,
everyone. Back, Tim.
Hello.
Surprise to even us.
It's also a surprise to me. Hooray.
I thought he wasn't going to be here.
I did not. I actually thought he was going to eavesdrop on us to make fun of us on the other podcast, but
I was going to
they went with Timbo.
I was going to open the Scoundrels live stream and like just report like, by the way, here's what Tim says about the thing.
It's dumb as shit.
Kyle says he's wrong.
Welcome back, guys. It's nice to have you back.
I will say there was supposed to be a podcast the last time involving both Tim and Will and Ryan. Yep. I was not there because I was not present.
Sure.
Because I was in the hospital. Sure. More on that later. But then Will decided to take a 7-hour nap, which threw the entire time.
That's true.
I was failing to remember that this is what happened, but yes, it did happen that way.
And then I was like, oh, we can just push it. And next thing I know, Ryan has brought in some scrub walkers. These are off the picket line. I was like,
well,
what the?
You just, said you
just
could
scab
make
their
it.
Way through.
And Tim
it was the
scab
cast.
I was like, oh, wow. So, out of all the jokes about me, we know that Ryan crossed the picket line. So there
that's
you
true.
Go.
It's true.
Oh, absolutely
I
did.
Made
it,
sure you,
really
you all had content, dear listeners.
And he's the hero
Maybe.
For it.
Hey, hold,
he's the
hold,
hero
hold.
For it, everyone.
No. Ryan, you were supposed to edit that episode over a period of 2 nights and release on a Wednesday.
Yeah. Work,
and then
work
you told
like
us,
a bag of truck. Yeah.
I'm going to get it done on Saturday.
Like a week.
What was the actual release date?
Like a bag of
yeah.
truck.
Oh, yeah. I love mixing metaphors,
we're,
man.
We're not going over that.
It was like 7 days late.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
You scab casted and then failed to produce.
It was 9 days late. Get your math right.
You recorded on the 9th and
true.
It released
on
the 26th.
I made sure it was out before Rocky Top Game Con, and someone was very busy prepping Rocky Top Game Con because all my help evaporated.
Steven?
Well, yeah, well, kind of, but
like a true
that's
Tennessee
a story
fan,
for
you keep
another
moving
day.
The goalposts. There you go.
So we talk about often how I don't play games, and now it's become a game of how long can Ben not play a game.
Uh-huh.
But I actually had a real thing happen, which means that I could not help with Rocky Top whatsoever.
Allegedly.
This is called The Story of Nine-Toed Ben and the Droid of Power.
I guess there'll be no This Week on the STABcast.
Yeah,
sorry. You had your chance, Will. You had your chance.
Take your guesses.
That's fine.
Fine. You add it in later. Add it
this week on the STABcast, we talk about stuff, I guess, sometimes.
Yeah, that's basically what it is. It's like, you'll hear about it this week on the STABcast as there's points, games, and medical conditions. That's the show.
Welcome, everybody.
We've already started
talk.
Off beautifully. I'm excited to be a part of this.
I'm a part of this.
So for those not in the know, I went to the hospital on May the 12th and did not come back out until May the 20th.
Yeah.
I had been walking around a lot, had some pain. I just thought I was walking around a lot kind of pain. No, turns out I developed an infection in my foot. Also, I was diabetic and my blood pressure was through the roof. So, long
story
short,
your breakfast of only a bottle of Dr. Pepper might have,
Listen,
but
it was
diet.
The only Dr. Pepper I drank for the day.
It was the only one that I had.
Yeah, that was. Yeah,
I mean,
I try my best not to.
Start
but sometimes
the day with a normal Dr. Pepper.
I was working 80-hour weeks.
Get home at
yeah,
9
no,
PM.
It was the work. We all knew Ben would break eventually.
It's the American way.
This way. Doctors came to me on a Monday morning. It's like, hey, so we're
Dr.
definitely going to take off your toe today.
Oh.
So, cool.
Farewell,
cool.
toe.
Point,
I
promoted
hardly knew
the next toe.
At
so,
least
yeah.
it wasn't an important one, right, Ben? It was like a middle toe or something like that?
No, it was my big toe. I'm lacking a left great toe, as they refer to it in the doctor's offices. The
you walk with a cane?
Toe. No, surprisingly, you can walk without a
That's
big
That's disappointing.
Toe. It's been...
Go back.
I am scarred and deformed.
I am deformed, though. It does look like when I'm wearing my bandage on my left foot and my sock on my right foot, it looks like I just have two right feet. Like where the big points are in the wrong directions on my left foot now. So Promoted Toe has struggled to fill the void left by Big Toe, but he's making it. He's going to make his way through it.
Did you fall down the stairs?
No, I've not done that yet, but it did take me 2 weeks of recovery. I went back to work for the first time today. Luckily, the kids have already left. Like, I just could not keep up with the kids, and the doctor was afraid of me breaking sutures while trying to run after the children, so he basically put me on home rest for 2 weeks. So I've been doing computer stuff and taking care of things. I have a cane, actually.
And also for the children, thank you. Cane. Yes, Will gets me. Will gets
me. You damn kids.
So 2.5 years ago, my dad fell out of a tree stand while hunting in the woods.
Oh, God.
He claims it was only 5 feet off the ground. I don't think that's true. He doesn't remember because he blacked out when he hit the ground.
But all right, yeah.
So my dad had a compound fracture of his left ankle. Like, you know, broken bones through the skin and all that jazz. And Will blanches every time I tell the story.
Yeah, I was about to say, I need photographic evidence of both this and your recent endeavors.
I've got your photos. No. I sent them to Tim. Tim's seen the photos.
No, we just need a live stream Will looking at these.
You offered to send me photos. And I said, no, just send them to my wife. That's it.
Yes. You went to live stream to Abby. Me Abby's vomiting. Like, that's fine. I mean,
people are into that.
Abby, Tim's wife, who is a surgical nurse who loves amputating people and has threatened us with amputation.
She loves amputating people, yes.
And threatens me with it every day.
Yes, every day. She threatened us on the STABcast with it a couple times. I said, ha, beat you to the punch. I've already amputated my own toe. So then she looked at the photos and then asked me what the drugs I was on. She's like, oh, that's the good stuff. Oh, Ben, you were really sick. I was like, yeah, I was.
Yes.
So, yeah, I played No Legion. I could not do Rocky Top whatsoever. In fact, Ryan came to pick up some boxes of terrain that were living in my house.
Yep.
Will dropped some terrain off. I was dead asleep when Will arrived. Like, I could barely get up to get downstairs to say anything to him.
Your mother told me to be on my way.
She did. She said, I don't think Benjamin Will knew how to upstairs. End this conversation.
Benjamin's upstairs. You may go now.
My question is, Will, how far is it to Ben's house for you?
Like 10 minutes.
Why did you just not, like, I was just confused on the logistics.
Ben will care for them.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
I mean, there is just
they stayed in my house. It was
my walls of my living room are still stacked with terrain, but yes.
So Ryan came to pick up some stuff a couple days after that because he has a very tiny car and I could not quite convince my sister to put all the stuff in her SUV and take it down. She was a little worried about the venue. I was like, Lindsay, I'll sit in the car with you.
Yeah.
She was still worried about the venue.
It's just these things.
So Ryan came to pick up all the boxes.
If you had a cane, you could chase people away. That gave her any problems.
From the car? Damn, kids. So Ryan comes to pick stuff up. I talked to him, but the next day I'm dead asleep.
Yep,
so I can't get up to talk to him. Then after Rocky Top, Ryan has a friend of his bring his SUV and bring stuff back to my house. I was also dead asleep when that happened, so Spencer met my sister. So
at that point, I was pretty sure you were dead. Like, we were not getting the daily required 17, like, TikTok links posted in our group chat. So we thought you were dead.
I only posted TikToks at night when I'm dissociating from my day. All right, let's keep it real. It's always after 8:30.
Yeah, but we weren't getting them.
you guys were not. Because he was on the good drugs. I really was sleeping 18 hours a day. Like, it was a...
We thought you were dead.
You finally caught up.
You know, this is the warning to all the people out there. If you're young and you got some weight on you, diabetes will come for you. I just be real honest. Right. I mean, if you're old and you got some weight on you, diabetes will come for you. You know, diabetes coming. I lost weight. At one point I was a 330-ish pound man. I got down to 225, 230-ish. I thought I was eating better, and I was. I dropped a lot of those bad carbohydrates. I just wasn't eating the right things at the right times. And work and stress, man. I have done nothing but work for the last year. I mean, I haven't played Legion in 6 months.
Yep.
I haven't actually played a game of Legion in 6 months. I pay attention to all of this. I look at all the notes. But you got to have that work-life balance, guys. You have to have that work-life balance.
Was your last match in Cincinnati?
Otherwise, you'll have no balance. Hey!
No, I played in December.
Oh, yeah, the December tournament thing we did. Yeah.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I played in December. That's where I won the gift card, which I've yet to spend. This is my house.
Right.
But all that being said, I'm going to have to make some changes in my life, work-life balance policies anyway. I have just bought my plane ticket to Orlando in October, so I'm definitely going to that. So now it's all the pieces
you,
put up.
You have a ticket
I may not
that,
go to
right?
Gen Con, but I have a ticket, yes, for Crucible.
Okay.
I do.
Crucible, okay.
Had the ticket, had the hotel. I was waiting on prices to come down on the airline. Now, it's Allegiant. It may mean my bags don't get there unless I strap them to myself.
They're going
to
take your other
ticket. Yeah, same price that I'm check paying, a bag.
But for the same price that I'm paying, I can just buy a second seat.
Right. So.
This seat is for my army.
It'll be fine. But like I said, you got to put that work-life balance out there, guys. You have to. Because, you know, if you're not alive to play the game, then what's the use of it? So I'm very happy to be here.
Or are we just discarding body parts to continue making excuses?
I'm pretty sure that's what Grievous did. So.
And you do like General Grievous.
Hey! I believe it was Tim that was just like, you know, Ben, you don't have to go this extreme for excuses not to play Legion.
Yeah, like you can just say you don't want to play. That's okay, man. Like, you don't got
to
do this.
It's all right. You don't have to. This is too far.
But if I had gone to Rocky Top, we would never have gotten the great joke that the Wish.com Ben Fowler is Brett Ringo.
Yes, we did.
That was absolutely worth it.
I don't understand, but I laugh anyway.
Was that worth your toe? I hope so.
Honestly, maybe. For a good solid joke, maybe.
Some days, probably.
That is how I introduced Brett at Rocky Top.
Well, yesterday, I woke up at 3 in the morning and drove to the Denver airport. And then flew from Denver to Knoxville, and then drove from the sort of in Knoxville airport directly to Sci-Fi City in order to play a game against Nathan Morgan.
Well done, sir.
Wow,
well done.
So you just flew all that way to lose?
Hey, I'm undefeated against Nathan Morgan, I'll have you know.
You are his kryptonite.
That's impressive. I didn't know that.
So I was playing Anakin Obi-Wan, and he was playing Dooku Ventress.
That's cool. That's awesome, actually.
Yeah.
Four force pushes on the table.
It's terrifying.
Ventress, all the pushes. He had a bunch of B1s. I had, you know, some clones. We played around for a little while. We were both kind of confused by the rules. We had some new objective cards.
Oh, okay.
We see where this is going. All right, neato.
Rex and Cody were also there.
Okay.
Kalani.
See, I wondered if this was going to be an MCP battle report, because I saw you play on Sunday, which is when MCP plays in Knoxville. Yeah.
But we used some terrain that Will Werner had built. It was on a 3x3. It was kind of weird.
Skirmish is stupid. I thought that's where we drew the line.
Oh, it wasn't skirmish.
Because we don't respect Spec Ops either.
No, not Spec Ops either.
Oh, the point is shattering.
Yes.
I'm shattering your talking points by playing Shatterpoint.
Yeah. I mean, you play MCP instead of Legion, so they might as well do Star Wars MCP.
It's not quite Star Wars MCP. I kind of like it more, honestly.
Okay, cool. That's good to hear.
Okay.
That's interesting. Then MCP?
If we're translating it into MCP, basically your power is now a team resource instead of by character, because that's what the force is.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
And so you have to balance who gets to spend the force per turn.
I like this.
And then you only get it back after you've activated everyone and you reshuffle your activation deck, which I also like that there's an activation deck, because MCP definitely has the issue of people like scripting their turn one openings to be like down to the last millimeter. And this game is just like, you draw and find out what's going. Have fun. So that immediately throws all that out the window. We were both obviously missing a ton of things because we were playing some non-core set mixed with core set. It was our first games for both of us.
Right.
But it's still really fun. I like the way that the objective resets and kind of favors the person who's behind. So that way it's not just win harder again.
Yeah, you got to catch up mechanic.
Yeah. It's basically the loser gets to pick the deployment map of the second objective. So like you play the first objective, reveal the second one, which has two maps, and the loser gets to pick which one is active, basically. It kind of helps that way. So the winner has to keep trying to win, and then the loser can try to pick
just the new
ones
objective reset, or does like the whole game kind of reset?
Damage and conditions and things on characters all stay, but points and the objective and who's controlling what, that all resets.
But do I have to pick up all my dudes and move them back to a deployment zone?
No, everyone stays where they were.
Okay, that's cool. That's neat. All right, I'm cool with that. I'm down with that.
Because right now there's 9 objectives on the table and only certain ones are active at a time.
Sure.
Hi, Daisy. Why are you yelling?
Daisy, take control.
Meow. Executive producer Daisy says this is off topic.
Yes.
I mean, this is off topic.
But it's good to know, though. It's good to know that it was fun.
It is good.
That's fine.
Peregrine's going to ban me.
So I'll be honest. He can't hurt you here. Somewhere over the weekend, I may have joined a Discord that was filled with old Decipher games. Like a whole bunch of the ones.
I figured you were a mod on one of those already.
I'm actually surprisingly not. So Decipher was a company that made a whole bunch of games that I played in my high school and college years. Like Lord of the Rings, and Star Trek, and Star Wars. And those kind of card games.
We're doing the Ben Feller deep cuts tonight. And not just the toads.
So I was just like, you got to beat me to it. Damn it.
So, but what I'm trying to get at is that we have done a lot of FFG games because FFG was the company that made things we liked. So we were paying a lot more attention to it. So I always like seeing how we translate concepts we know into other concepts. So, like, we talk about how Guild Ball has a very similar, like, you roll dice and then you move up a chain of things. How do those stances work? Like, now that you guys have actually played it.
In Guild Ball terms, instead of just rolling and seeing how many successes you get, it's kind of more like MCP, where you roll a number of attack and a number of defense and you cancel. And then you look at the number of successes you have remaining and go up the track that many. The main difference is, A, you can't wrap around and go over the track again. So they are capped.
Okay.
Which is another way of balancing characters, because they know exactly, you know exactly how much damage Anakin can possibly do, because he has 8 damage on his track total, and that's all he'll ever be able to do at once, for instance. But then in those things, there's like conditions and pushing your opponent away and all kinds of results that can affect the game itself. And then primary characters always have 2 different options, which they can change that at any time during their activation, once per activation. So you can flip from usually a melee intense mode to either a defensive mode, or maybe like a, like Maul has one that's a saber throw, so it has a ranged attack. They're interesting. I enjoy them. I was worried about the game being a little more dicey, but since it doesn't have the critical hits exploding like Marvel, I honestly think it's a little less dicey than that.
You hit me one time for like 20 damage.
Yeah, like sometimes in Marvel, you're just like, oh, that's 5 crits. I add 5 more dice to my roll now. And there's something to be said about having a game where nothing is at 0% chance. That's kind of neat.
That's nice.
But also that means that nothing is guaranteed either sometimes. Like,
well, taking the 2 points you've kind of made, it sounds like they've made a bit of a trade-off where that's less quote-unquote dicey, but you're also having to activate out of a deck, correct? Where you can't make as informed decisions on when your units go, so that's adding a element of randomness where that's very set in Marvel.
Right.
So maybe dicey isn't the right word, but like, is the variance around the same?
A little bit, but you also have some control over that activation deck. If you pull a character, you can spend one of your team's force points to put that card in reserve instead of going with them right then.
Okay, that's cool.
And then from then on, you can either use your reserved card or the top of the deck before drawing. So you like, if you're activation 1, turn 1, and you draw your like Anakin Skywalker and you're like, well, shit, I didn't want him to go right now. You can spend a force and be like, so he's not going right now, and now I can pull him whenever I want. It's not entirely based on the deck. And then there's also one in there that's a wild activation. It's called the Shatterpoint card. They said the name. Which does allow shenanigans where you can pull that card and activate a character a second time. I think it has a fun amount of variance.
So what I'm hearing is this might become a Shatterpoint podcast now for you. So there you go.
I'm still going to be playing Legion, especially with some things that may have been released today.
Some things that might have happened. Yeah. Oh.
Some things that may have happened.
I just figured we had no content, so we just talked about Shatterpoint the whole time. It'd be great.
My
I'm
swamp
fine with
boats,
that.
They call to me.
I'll be honest, up until too, like 5:30, I thought we were going to have no content. Like, oh, look at that, content.
Well, I knew I'd be making this joke about Shatterpoint.
Yeah, that's fair.
I mean, I thought it'd be Wilford Brimley jokes all night, so.
But to get back to Shatterpoint. the big upset of the Shatterpoint battle report is that Nathan did defeat me.
Hey.
Oh. So now you never play it again.
He's retiring from Legion, everybody. It's all Shatterpoint now.
Yep.
All right. But Will, you're the hobby man, and these are bigotries.
These are cool. Like, these are cool.
They're beautiful. Oh my gosh, they are beautiful.
I mean, honestly, if Daisy ever kills you and eats your corpse, I am going to break in and steal all of your marble, because I do like the way you've painted them. Like, they really look fantastic. I mean,
thanks.
Well, that's not true. I'll make a good offer to your mother for a nice princely sum.
And she'll say, get these out of here.
Exactly. For free. Yes. Yeah. Excellent. Thank you, ma'am.
If you show up and get them out of the house, that's fine. Yeah.
The plastic crack killed my son.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Heim. I understand he gave you no grandchildren. May I take these miniatures out of your way? Excellent. Thank you, ma'am.
Well, Mother Heim has been caring for the cat over the last 2 weeks I was in Colorado, and now I think she wants her own cat. So.
There you go. Daisy's influence grows. Maybe Daisy should start a podcast.
I think so. She's very charismatic, much more than me. But to the quality of the miniatures, they are fantastic, yes. I think they're going to be a lot easier to paint because they are MCP scale. They come with pre-made plastic bases like Marvel, but I'm not as thrilled with the Star Wars themed ones. Like, they're kind of like sidewalk and desert, sort of. It's kind of odd.
Are there rocks? Do we have rocks?
The core set has no tactical rocks. It has Mandalorians that are floating on jetpack smoke, but Wave 2 has Grievous, and he's standing on a giant toppled over Jedi statue. So
that counts. That's cool. We're taking it.
Yeah.
So
with these minis, I mean, obviously, I'm not the hobby guy. I don't know. I know they do have those like pre-custom made bases, but is that something that can easily be hobbied over and you can do your own?
Oh yeah, the minis are completely separate from those bases, so you can choose whatever bases you want.
That's cool. Okay.
Just come with sculpted ones to begin with if you just want to use those instead. Like considering
how
clear bases.
How customizable are the poses? Can you rearrange some legs a little bit to get some better poses or some different poses? Or are they kind of stuck in the...
Most of the big characters are pretty locked in place. Like they're engineered to be assembled a certain way. The B1 droids have some flexibility, and Kalani has a bit as well, because he's, you know, just, you can point his arms different directions if you want. But most everyone else is pretty much locked in the way they are. So it is going to be a bit samey as far as like, this is Asajj. She always looks like this. But until we get a different version of Asajj one day, perhaps, you never know.
Well, I mean, I think we have a precedent of that in MCP. We've had a handful of characters duplicated.
Oh, we already have that in Shatterpoint, because they've announced Padawan Ahsoka is coming out.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
Because right now we have Season 7 Ahsoka.
So I will say, as the old man of this podcast, the Wilford Brimley of this podcast, I completely get why this is all prequel faction stuff to start off with. The people who saw those films when they were 10 are now nearly 30 years old or plus.
So,
that makes complete sense.
Me and Ryan, yes?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
And I will take another look at Shatterpoint when the Ghost Crew and like Han and Chewie come out.
And they're coming. They're coming.
I'm sure they are. Absolutely, I'm sure they are.
The Inquisitors are, I think, like wave 2 or 3 of releases. So, and they're going to be pumping those boxes out.
Okay. So are there other MCP Imperial stuff out already? I thought it was just Clone Wars, like end of Clone Wars stuff.
No, they said Clone Wars.
They've announced the OT stuff, but Inquisitors are the first ones we're seeing that are on the release schedule.
That's cool.
Apart from the Vader versus Obi-Wan diorama from the Obi-Wan TV show, I guess. And I think that comes with a Vader card in it. So
that's neat.
From that preview piece, I think it does. But the models look good. Like I said, this company
they look fantastic
about model design. And I like the artwork. The artwork surprised me because it's different from the FFG stuff. We were talking about this pre-show. I love FFG artwork, but they bought a ton of it and have been recycling it through a lot of products. And so, you know, their alt art cards for this upcoming tournament circuit look nice, but we've seen that art before. And
yeah,
so this
like is if you've played the LCG or played the RPG, like, the art is amazing. But if you only interact with one property, you get something new every time. If you're a whore like I am, it's been around a while.
Right.
I mean, there's times I've been like, I've seen that art in Armada. That's weird. Yeah. I saw the X-Wing. That's why.
No, yeah, the art's really cool, and it's also used on all the like order cards that you pull, so you're definitely seeing it like all over the place, this whole like kind of
that style.
Design style. Yeah, it's neat and I enjoy it. The cards are all giant and easy to read. Like stances are a little hard to get through the first time, but once you kind of play through it the first few times, you're just like, "Okay, I got 3 successes, so that's 4 damage, a shove, and a pinned condition." Okay.
I can see the iconography being hard, but...
We spend a lot of time having to research, like, what the conditions do, and, like, characters have a number of wounds, but then they can be injured a certain number of times before they're taken out of the game. And something that I like is even if you get put to your like, health threshold, like, you are killed by damage tokens, you aren't dead until the end of your next activation.
Interesting. Ew,
so you have one last gasp.
So even when you are, like... shot to hell, you get one last like run to a thing.
E-stims for everyone.
You know, IG-11 and IG-88 have a card like that in this game called Star Wars Legion. It's a really cool game. We should try it sometime.
As we are a half an hour into this podcast.
Are we supposed to talk about that?
Just a little bit of news that happened today. I thought maybe we'd talk about it, but you know, maybe I was wrong. That's okay. It's fine.
Rocky God, Top Game. Fine. Ryan, how'd that work out for you?
as aforementioned, I have the Wish.com Ben Fowler as my backup. I have to give a huge shout out. Rocky Top would not have happened without Landon and Brett from our local community, who stepped in a big way and helped me out running the admin desk and check in at the front gate and helping me with judge calls. We had 57 players show up.
Nice.
And
doesn't that make you the largest tournament on the East Coast?
By one. Absolutely it does. Suck it, Nick. PAX, I'm sure, and Crucible will probably surpass us. But for now, Crucible. Good
times.
But You know, maybe we can find that sweet spot as Rocky Top is the biggest event in the country between Worlds and Gen Con, which is not a bad little badge of honor to have, to be competing with those two. So, no, it was an awesome event. The table competition was amazing. We had tables come from all over the country. I think we had 10 states and 2 continents represented. So that was pretty cool. All of the players, like, we were all hemming and hawing about the points update, whether it was going to come in time, what it was going to do for list building. I was of the opinion that if it hits last week, we were just going to play with the new points because, like, we're tired of oppressive Dark Troopers. And it didn't come, but all the players were still super chill. I didn't have any contentious tables. Everybody was there just to have a good time, play with their opponents and make friends. And
nice.
It blew me away. We had a really good mix of lists and factions. We only had one Op Vader Blizzard Force in 57 lists. I want to say that there was no Dark Trooper Palpatine Royal Guard shenanigans. It was pretty cool. And the stunning thing is when it was all said and done, we had 2 undefeateds, Austin Miller with his Blizzard Force, and it was Kentucky Dan's Black Sun was our other finalist. They both went undefeated, but in the top 5, you know, I always give a best in faction prize away. And in our top 5 players were 5 unique factions. And to me, when we complain about the meta and things being stale, it fell that way. So that was super cool. It was like Sabine and like SX-21s, like the Thorian shotgun guys. Sabine Ahsoka was our rebel list. JJ playing Obi-Wan, I think, was our best Republic. Like there was some wild stuff. Nice. But it was a really cool event. The vendors gave us a ton of prize support. A shout out to Ninetales Hobbies donated for us a raffle for a custom painted, like a commission commander or operative. And he had a booth right next to our play area. And he's like, hey, if you guys buy all of my terrain and all of my painted Star Wars Legion stuff, I'll raffle off a second one. And by lunch break of Sunday, we had sold all of his stuff.
Nice.
So, and he was like, I was a little worried coming out. It's my first con as a commission painter, like owning a booth. And the Legion stuff did really well for him. So he's going to be doing more for us in the future. His stuff looks great. And guys, if you're looking for a commission painter, he had a painted, and I was like, if it's still sitting there Sunday, I'm going to buy it. But a painted Ahsoka, like better than obviously I could paint, for $45. You get all the cards and cardboard and plastic. Yeah. And like, that's a $20 expansion just by itself.
Yeah.
So I'd pay that. 20. Yeah, absolutely. $25 for a painted mini. You guys can find him on Facebook, Instagram, all the things. He's on the Legion Discord. You guys, if you are looking for a commission painter to get a special model done, go find him and tell him we sent you. But Rocky Top was awesome. I really don't have much more to say than the players made it absolutely incredible. Ben reserved us for his memorial a couple tables at Schultzbrau. And I want to say we had like 35 people of the 57 up.
That's nice.
Yeah,
I do miss Schultzbrau every day.
It was absolutely amazing.
I was a little worried it was going to rain that weekend. Like, I was kind of worried because you were in the outside covered spot, but you got to walk between the place. And
no, it was absolutely incredible. Because those for me, like, the tournaments are fun, the games are fun, but the dinner and the socializing and the trash talk afterwards at dinner is always the most fun. And I could not have asked for a better weekend and better players and better help from Brett and Landon. I haven't played much Legion because everything has been getting ready for Rocky Top and then decompressing from Rocky Top. So
yeah,
I don't really have much to report, but I think I have a valid excuse.
That's fair.
I'll play my Ben Fowler card.
Well, so
term is a thing.
Yes, exactly. Yes. I finally got to play for the first time pretty much since Adepticon. Because I've been busy.
Hey,
nice.
I did play like the week right after Adepticon, and that was about it. Because I got to try Asajj, and it was a lot of fun. And I got to try Asajj versus Asajj, and that was the last time I played.
much Asajj.
Yes, exactly. It was a good training, I guess.
So, by the way, so at some point when Tim thought he would be the only one with a game and was not going to be on this podcast, he sent us as actually like, this is what I happened, just in case you need to use it. in case we had no games to talk about.
Oh, yes, exactly.
So thoughtful.
You're welcome. You know, I'm always thinking of you, always thinking of the people. Exactly.
Well, since there's no fun on Scoundrels and you don't do bat reps, you know, it's fine. We can just
we do a little bit. We do a little bit. Just we do summaries. We just make them take, you know, 10 minutes instead of half an hour. That's all. But anyway, so I got a chance to play at a local tournament up here in Buffalo, actually, which is only about an hour and change away, hour and 15. So
I thought you were in Buffalo. Isn't that the same city?
He's in Rochester.
We are all in Western New York, all right? We're in the Western New York Legion Facebook. So there you go. But we had a nice little tournament.
Told me it stood for Worthless New York, but the W stood for Worthless.
I don't think I ever said that, but okay.
It was implied.
You did, actually. I think you said anything that wasn't New York City was...
Oh, yes.
You said
when he's
everything
not even from New York
Western
City.
New York City was Western New York.
So. I'm from here, okay. But anyway.
Now, yeah,
Long
that was
Island.
Also Western New York.
Yeah, what happened to Long Island, Sam?
I'm also from there.
You
I'm
can't afford there. Long Island.
That's also true.
That's exactly.
But I got to play a local tournament. It was just a small little bit. About, we did have, I think, 12 people, but then some people had some stuff come up last minute. So we got down to 9, but it was a lot of great time.
Honestly, for a one-day Saturday tourney, that's not a bad number.
No, it was good. It's like a good size. And again,
like Dicehead.
And again, normally you have a few more than that, but people had some stuff come up. But sure. We had some great people come out. I got 3 rounds in. So got to play Joe. I'm not going to pronounce your last name correctly, but it's got some cool Z's and Y's in it. It's great. Pizerbal. We're going to go say Pizerbal. That's great. So I was playing, Pizerbal. By the way. I was playing a Cody list.
Ew.
And he was also playing a Cody list. It was a Cody versus Curdy. Curdy?
Curdy.
Cody.
Cheese Curdy?
It's Cody when you leave him out of the fridge a little too long. He's
Commander Curdle.
Sniff test first.
No, Cody did not curdle this weekend. But anyway, my list name was Furry Cody. I was right at 9 activations, right at 800. Clone Commander, naked. Cody with aggressive tactics, 3 phase 2s, 2 of them with a Z6, and then 5s in the third one.
Mm-hmm.
2 Wookiees with bowcasters and prepared supplies, and they're the melee Wookiees. Echo and an arc strike, and then a lone ATRT with a laser cannon. And it was a lot of fun. We had a great time. Again, his was a more standard Cody list of barks, if there's a standard one yet. I think people are still exploring. And we got down to the wire, got super nitty-gritty, but even though scale has been nerfed a little bit, I got to climb over the other side of the rock and drop down and grab a box, and it was recovered supplies, and I was able to run away. I was red player all 3 games, got the box, ran away, and got that last box and was able to secure that one. Round 2, got to play Tiffany. And Tiffany was fantastic. Her husband was there as well. And he had, unfortunately had to get the bye the first round, but then he was able to play the second round. And we had a grand old time. She had Maul with, unfortunately, no force push on there. So it was a little bit dicey when he got into melee with some Wookiees. He jumped over, got into melee with Wookiees, and then they punched him a whole bunch. And then he had to withdraw, and he withdrew. And then he got fire supported to death, and it was a bit
That's
of a sad
how it
time.
Goes.
I do. Mm-hmm. It was 5 rounds. We were playing Breakthrough, and I did realize about halfway through, even though I was killing a lot of stuff, I was like, "Ooh, I need to run! Like, if I don't run, she could sneak like a unit leader back here and actually
you
win
see,
this
Tim,
thing."
The movement tool helps you move points. Units towards the objective, which is Breakthrough.
Well, yes, but
instead of taking
but
an
all
aim
of her
token
forces
and
were
then
coming in.
Dice.
But when they're all just running towards you, like you're just like, I just want to sit here and fire support.
I know, but
man.
It's,
like,
it's knowing when
it.
You have to switch brains.
I will say, every time Gar Saxon took a shot at my Wookiee squad, he killed a Wookiee.
He does.
It was 3-3-3 blank 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 blank. They never saved.
And even if
they
did, he has
died.
Pierce 1. So
the unit leader finally made it out alive on like 1 health, literally 1 health. But anyway, got down to turn 5 and end of turn 5. I did manage to pull off a table, which I felt a little bad about. But we were like, we don't really want to play around 6. So
I guess
there
it
we go.
Worked out.
It was fun. She's a really great opponent. She was. A
I
lot
really
of fun
need
to play.
Tim to or Will to live narrate Tim's games.
That was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. And then her and her husband were wonderful. We talked about the game a whole bunch and talked about Scoundrels a little bit. Sorry, guys, but talked about Scoundrels a little bit and good times.
I got to ask the question. Yeah. So you brought up force push and lack of force push.
Yes.
is this not the reason why we probably shouldn't have it?
If they feel unplayable without it, should it be?
Get out of here.
There's a different conversation to have, I think, that we should just bake it into all Force users. But anyway.
You have been on Scoundrels avoiding topics. Look at you.
Oh, man. That's funny. Third.
Force push is awesome. Makes the game dynamic.
Third round, awesome. I got to play Andrew Pulaski.
That's what I'm saying.
And everybody has access to it. I'll
just stop. Fine. Talk about your third game.
Sorry. I definitely derailed it, Tim. That's definitely my bad. I like to derail on this topic because I definitely think it needs some changes. I did. It was all me.
I got to play.
Let Tim know it was me.
Finally got to play Double Dark. There you go. Finally got to play against him. It was Double Dark IRG Gideon list with a.
Did you cry? Shore did you urinate yourself and attempt to?
It was really frustrating to have to defend against a critical 2 suppressive shot from a Dark's fire supported by a mortar, but. I made it through. Yep, it was key positions, and I did towards the end of the game. So a couple things happened. A, I forgot lethal on Cody at least once, if not twice, which was almost cost me the game. And I made it out, but whew, man. And I also forgot some of Cody's cool observe abilities because I put some observe tokens on Gideon to give him suppressive, and then half my shots didn't have suppressive because I forgot I had those. So that was a good time.
I'm
trying to remember triggers. Yeah, it was a new unit, so I've never played with him before. So learning new things is always fun. And he did deep strike his dark troopers behind me, and if your opponent has impact pierce, don't do that.
Maybe you don't.
So I was just able to turn around. Yeah, my AT-RT was able to just back up and just shoot him with the laser cannon, got him at range 2, and fire supported that and was able to get him there. And then at the end of the game, it was final round, and it's KP, and the KP was a rock, and I was like, hey man, are we having a good time? He's like, yeah. I was like, you want to, like, what are we just having fun? Are we trying to win? He's like, well, I'd like to win. I was like, all right, I'd probably like to win too, so okay. So this is the thing I can do, and so I moved the ATRT onto the rock. I asked first.
Did you say, I don't think your question was really leading into that answer, though.
Yeah.
Are we having fun? No. But, stomp.
So I did that. I pushed him off a little bit, but he did manage to claim a box and clear up a little corner. So he did touch the corner again, but then I was able to fire support the touching unit off.
No touchy.
Was able to score the win, and I got to go 3-0 and won the tournament. The hell? How about that?
What?
Here we go. Good times.
Tim hasn't won that many games since that one Invader League.
Hold on. Is this your first win? Is this your first big tournament win?
Big.
No.
No. No.
No.
Okay.
No.
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 I didn't know. I know when you were down here.
No.
Have you won a dice head event?
I've won smaller events. I've never won a big event. The best I've ever done in a big event
was ACO, right?
It was other Dallas, right?
Other Dallas, yeah. The first tournament back from COVID.
Dallas Open, not the Lone Star Open.
No, but I know you got third at Dallas Open, but is this your first tournament that you have been in first place in?
I don't think so, but maybe. I don't know. It's been 5 years, so I don't remember.
Okay, I was going to congratulate you, but I guess I won't.
Thank you. If it is, it very well might be. I'm not denying it completely.
It's like,
it could be, but I don't remember.
If I have, it's like some 8-man dice head where
I've not been keeping track.
And just like, after two rounds, I'm in first, guess. Like, you know.
Exactly, yeah. But, anyway, so it was a good time. It was a great time. Thank you to Alec Ryer for setting it all up. I think next time we should have some more people, especially with the new points and everything like that. So
the new what?
But yeah, I got some Legion. Aha! What a tease!
Hey, Legion!
It's not the news yet. Shut your whore mouth.
Real question. Did anybody take photos of any of the things they did?
I did.
Where are they?
Brett said he was sending it to you. He was like on it
I
for taking
photos
from, of Rocky
from
Top.
Will Werner from Rocky Top to post to our
Instagram. I will put some from Stabcast North. I will put some photos onto the Stabcast Instagram for us just for those. How about that? There you go.
Yeah. There's in our Gmail drive, there's like 200 photos, I think, that Brett took.
Would have been cool to know about.
He does those things. God bless him.
So someone should be posting those to the Instagram. You check us out for some cinematic moments at SWStabcast. You'll find some of those photos, perhaps somewhere, posted.
Did we all just have one long Instagram plug?
Yes.
I think that's what we did.
Down to, yes.
I think well, that's absolutely what we
did.
Be
sure well to also team. Check us out on Facebook and Twitter and give us a rating on your listening platform of choice. We appreciate it. It helps us boost through the algorithm and be viewed by more and more Legion folk. As I play more and more Shatterpoint and twist your minds to play the new Atomic Mass Games product until we're all Atomic Mass Games soldiers.
We're all Atomic Masses here.
Uh-huh. We all go to Seattle HQ now.
I do like Seattle.
We will say,
Spotify had a special gift for me today, and it was not a podcast about Legion. So I was like, oh, that's sad.
I've been listening to some new Legion podcasts.
It was not.
We are on the Legion Discord. I mostly lurk these days because I've been busy. I haven't had time to dive into it recently, but I was there today was due to some news, you know, popping in, dropping my 2 cents, and then leaving.
Causing chaos.
Technically,
because they would have picked your 2 cents and thrown those pennies right back at you.
Hey, someone liked my comment. I forget who.
Didn't you get to report someone for being off topic? Wasn't that the peak of your entire life?
Oh, I did. That's right. That was last week. I got bored at work, so I drew two of the admins off topic and then yelled at them for being off topic. And then I got put in timeout. It was great. And I deserve it. And I'm not sorry.
I'm going to copy a joke from a week ago. I see that the University of Rochester pays you well.
Okay. Yes, yes. Got a promotion, actually. So, yes, there you go. Man.
Just goes to show you, hard work will get you killed. Right, Ben?
That's what I was going to say. Too soon.
I work real hard at my job, and it nearly killed me.
That's right. But yes, I actually just started streaming again last week. So fun fact, I haven't done any Legion again recently, but I had to boot everything back up, you know, update some graphics and stuff like that.
Put your 5th Trooper logos on it.
I was streaming Starship Troopers, actually, funny enough.
Just streaming the movie as a pirate? Fun game to stream.
No, the video game came out.
just streaming the movie until you get DMCA'd.
It's a 16-person survival game.
Look, that's too soon, Will. Too soon. You know what you did.
That was 4 years ago.
And I'm still on a list because of it.
Ben, it's a 16-person survival game. And so you just have to survive the bug swarm coming at you. And they're like, they're coming. And it's...
So it's...
And then like
Call
when
of
you
Duty
finally
zombies,
secure the...
Bugs.
You secure the point long enough, and then you have to exfil. And then normally the exfil is like halfway across the map, and so you're just running and gunning and
dying.
You're like, Johnny, we got they've got a person counter on the top. It says like 16 out of 16 still alive. And then all of a sudden, like right towards the end, it'll start dropping. You're like 7, 6, 5, and then like 7 of us made it out alive. All right, boys, there we go.
You've all been promoted.
That's
the only thing I need from that game is if there is a tutorial every time to go to the next slide or info panel, I need like microphone has to say, would you like to know more? And you have to verbally affirm.
I don't know if you verbally affirm. I know that. But I do think they do say that a couple times at least. Yes.
How fascist Doogie Howser are we getting in this game?
Oh, no, you're just shooting. Like you're just a grunt. You're just shooting.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
I've been avoiding making jokes about Tim and Star Trek Troopers this entire time.
I'm very proud of you.
He's doing his part.
We shall see.
Reporting the...
I mean...
It is still a pre-release. There are still things that are teased on it. You can either be a medic, a sniper, or a gunner right now.
And now we are a Starship Troopers video game podcast. Anyway, if you want to support the
STABcast, we have t-shirts door.
You can go to our Teespring shop. Yeah. Capitalism. Hooray. Just like Starship
Troopers.
That's
right. I'm the problem, everyone.
But Tim would be the Johnny Rico from Buenos Aires.
He would. That's true. You can go to teespring.com/store/STABcast or write us at swstabcast@gmail.com.
No, he'd be Jake Busey, guys.
I tried.
How dare you?
Is that the one that gets his brain sucked out?
We've got 10 minutes of Legion content in our 45 minutes in so far. It's great.
We have. So speaking of all the services, all the podcasts coming together for strong charities... Will and I were invited by Tim to join the Legion Fantasy Football
We are representing the STABcast.
To raise money for charity.
Yes,
Tim is not.
We're representing the STABcast. But Tim invited us.
I was busy representing others.
The 5th Trooper.
The 5th Trooper, yes. Myself and Doc.
How was there no one else in their 80-person roster that could play fantasy football?
We were the most football fanatics, I guess. And there you go. That's it.
But the team is run by a British man. The entire league is run by a man who doesn't understand
how
football works.
There's four British people playing, and again, one of them helped organize it.
I listened to their show about it, where they had an American football pop quiz. So go check out That's No Moon if you want to hear the British folks try to understand football.
Those guys are awesome. It is a good show. It's a fun show.
So
yeah.
For the first time in my life, I'm in a league that's bigger than
12. A 20-man fantasy league, I had the number one draft pick.
It is a little bit large.
I haven't seen a draft pick in 3 days. For some reason, though, we're also drafting all defensive players in addition to a defensive line, which I've never done in the 17 years.
I may be a co-commissioner, but I did not set up the draft, so I wash my hands of that. So there you go.
To show you the quality of our league, Tim is the American...
Yeah, that speaks volumes.
The best part was I was put in that position partially because of the time zone changes and like, okay, we're just gonna have an American side and UK side for time zone things. Uh-huh. And then right when the draft started, I went to Hawaii.
Yes, you did.
So in one of those bizarre shockers, and we'll talk more about this as season goes on, but because there's so many players and because apparently Europe takes August off, we had to start our draft Memorial Day weekend.
Well, that's like wild.
Every pick like, has I don't do 8 hours fantasy football thing, to pick their player in case, you know, you're sleeping or on a plane or something, which I understand.
I mean, yeah, so you guys should be done by July.
We're like a third of the way through now.
We hope. Around 10.
We're almost there. We're getting there. I'm going to switch to auto draft soon because now it's going to be
there's so many trash players that I've never heard of now.
I know.
Well, hang on. Tim, you drafted Tua. Tua was like your first
that
draft
was
pick.
The I was like, that was me. The best thing we had because all the good quarterbacks got
it's
taken.
True.
I was
picking last in the 16. First round.
That man's a walking concussion.
Yeah. Picking last in the first round is like being in round three of a normal league draft. It's so weird.
Yeah, you're just gone.
First round.
Yeah, I picked first, and then 40 picks later, I picked
so mad, Tim. You managed to snipe my pick in the first round. I wanted Josh Jacobs so bad.
Oh, Josh Jacobs. He won me some games last year. Yeah, he's
one of the good players on the Raiders. Yeah. One of the, like, three of them.
He carried my team one game. Yeah. Like, I was down. I was out. And then he got 30 points. I was like, okay, I guess we're going to win then.
But, Tim, you have made so many questionable decisions in
drafting. Oh, just in drafting? I thought we were just talking about Tim.
There's just – well, just also in general, yes. Yes, but there's no one left to draft, there's nothing left but questionable decisions.
I didn't know there was someone in the NFL named DeForest Kelly, but they got drafted, so I mean...
Listen, you're not going to draft Bones?
I thought you might, or DeForest Buckner, that's his name. He plays for the Colts.
I mean...
My favorite are the people drafting the
current... Will drafted a man who isn't going to play the first 6 years.
I was going to say...
Because the last 10, he might do great, I don't know.
Or also the people that drafted the unsigned agents right now. I'm like, I hope they get a team.
Yeah,
good luck.
Just drafted Zeke, yeah.
Well, also
you drafted a man who hasn't played in like 2 years, Rashad Penny.
But he's in Philadelphia now. They run the ball everywhere.
If I was Will Heim, this is where I would get up to take a shit.
I would like Ben to take a moment to explain his fantasy league football team name because everyone else has made a Star Wars pun and you chose what?
I chose Enterprise 17 wins or 17 wins 0-1 Super Bowls because I went for an Enterprise joke. So
that's a stretch.
Imagine if your league name was funny.
That's a stretch.
were you on your good pills when you made that?
Oh no, absolutely not. I was definitely not. Well, yes, I guess I was. Actually, let me say that. Yes, I was.
That explains a lot.
Between the combination of those and the antibiotics, I'm sure I was not thinking clearly whatsoever. So.
And probably caffeine withdrawals.
But anyhow, we will come down to someone who's going to win some money for charity.
Yes.
It's all for charity.
Yes.
And so we can talk about it across our platforms, you know, talk about those things. So
September, October, you'll hear us shouting about it if I have to play Tim or Ben or something.
Exactly. Know? It'll happen. It'll happen.
Yes.
Lots of big names in here, though. You know, LJ, Peregrine, all kinds of folks.
Oh, yeah. TFT,
the guy who ran the second largest East Coast tournament.
Legion 99, you mean?
Yeah, them.
Doc Velo's a lot of fun. There's apparently a couple Baltimoreans in here, so it's pretty amazing.
We keep fighting about how to spell words in English or American English. And Doc Velo is very...
Apparently Doc Velo edits all the pieces.
I caught him with a double negative before. It's okay. So it's all right.
It's a lot of people from Seattle who don't support Seattle. So that's always fun to talk about.
That's the most Seattle thing you can do.
It really is the most Seattle thing you can do. Will, did we decide what our charity is?
We're still undeclared. If you'd like to pick,
you have a, until like the
we
end.
Talked about it, but we didn't have any strong feelings.
If you'd like to pick a diabetes charity, that'd be Topicals.
I felt that was too topical. I didn't want to go that route. I don't oppose it. There was some epilepsy, but the Wilford Brimley Institute for Diabetes Studies.
Charity to be decided. Hold, please.
But Ben, if you then get money from it, is that like, do we have like an embezzlement case?
insider fantasy football trading.
It's a conflict of interest.
I definitely want to do some Arrested Development jokes here. Some good, strong.
Is it a conflict of interest to donate hoping they cure your disease?
I feel like it probably
is. I don't know.
We
need an internet lawyer to help us.
But you know, what you can do, after this episode airs, you could go and support your locals at the Ruckus at Rodia, the Bayou Wars, and
if you have internet and are in that area.
It's true.
They're fine people. We keep talking about it, but it's happening this weekend, June 10th and 11th.
It is.
It's about done.
Poisoned you're
not
going to
do it.
Supply.
You're going to miss it. You're going to miss the chance to be eaten by an alligator while playing.
There's no snakes in your boot. You got this. And then if you're...
Tim, I hear you're flying out.
I am. I'm going over in July, going down to Dallas for Lone Star Open. I'm looking forward to it. Missed it last year, but got to go 2 years ago, and it was so fun. It was
one
of my favorite
tournament.
Events. Probably my favorite
tournament
venue, honestly. I can't think of a better venue.
That hotel is awesome.
Because even for LVO, like LVO is a better city. But the venue for LVO, you have to walk like halfway through the casino to get to the.
You have to use your legs.
Actual
Texas
Legion.
Is built where you never have to do that.
It's great because you're right across from a shopping center. There's all the food right there. You have to go outside and then survive for at least 30 seconds.
You have to cross the 8-lane highway to go across a single street.
yes, but it was a good time. Maybe this time I'll go to what was it called the Velvet Taco? Yeah, maybe I'll go to Velvet Taco this time. It'll be a good time. It'll be fun. But yes, that's in July. So there's still, I think, a couple tickets left. They're close to sold out.
Our good friend Florf the Dwarf is one of the administrators on that. So
yes.
I'm proud
that
he's doing that thing. So, although Florf had fantastic success with a list I did not expect this past weekend.
Yeah, he's got his world's invite finally after God knows how many years.
Well, it's about time. He earns it.
Now he's just got to lobby to get that height requirement removed.
You must be this high to play Legion.
Oh, that's sad, but so true.
Here in June, though, after the Ruckus at Rodeo, but before Lone Star, you guys can also go to the Atlantic City Open if you want, I guess. Sadly, I'm not going back this year. I can't make it back this year.
I can't be there either.
But it is an event. You guys should go support Brandon, or Brendan, who's running it from Inglourious Blasters. But then, the biggie after Lone Star is the Gen Con, August 3rd through the 6th. Tim's going. I'm probably going to be there. I don't have my ticket yet, but I will probably be there in some way, shape, or form because it's the best convention of the year by a country mile.
Yeah. I have the Gen Con hotel and badge, but I have no event tickets because I was definitely at a place where I couldn't do anything on that Sunday. So
you were being operated on, I believe.
I was. So I'm not real sure if I'm actually going or if I got a decent hotel. It's not connected.
I was about to say, I'm just going to hopefully buy that hotel off you. That's what I'm hoping to do.
I mean, it's a Conrad. It's a nice hotel. I mean, and we're not
sleeping in a dumpster
like
back.
Right around when I'm moving to Denver. So
it's normal.
Probably not going to happen for me.
Probably not happening then.
Definitely not happening for me.
Right.
Let's see.
I'll be there.
Cool.
And I got in. I did get into the Deep Haven mega game. So that's good.
Oh, that was nice.
So I got Deep Haven.
See, the mega games were a thing because I didn't get into any of that. So
what's funny was I was at the PGA that was here in town in Rochester, and it hit the time to go on, and I couldn't have good service, and so I didn't get on to submit my event list until 12:15, and those 15 minutes, ladies and gentlemen, I was over 11,000th in line.
Mm-hmm.
That's Gen Con.
11,000th.
Yeah.
And so I didn't get Deep Haven at first. I got Junta, which is the same company, just different one. All the Lorcana sold out immediately, of course. And so I was really sad I didn't get Deep Haven. And then I just kept refreshing, kept looking, and some schmuck dropped his ticket. And I went, bam, got it. And I immediately added it and grabbed it. So there you go. Uh-huh.
I would say Gen Con's a little bit later this year because, they always rotate. And so I might be able to pull that one off. I might.
This is why I like Adepticon more. I don't like being 11,000th in line.
Well, normally I wouldn't be. I just couldn't refresh.
I mean, but where else am I going to spend lots of money on games I'm only going to play
the
twice
internet?
When I bring them back?
Anywhere?
So. Right?
I've got to say there's great things going on in Huntsville, Alabama. The Rocket City Championship has theirs in September. I've been following along with their Discord when I spent a lot of time on my phone hanging out in the hospital. And so they just had a great little turnout. Like, really, Legion is popping up in Huntsville. They don't travel far, but like I said, you get down there to play if you can. So good stuff going on there.
And then, of course, at the end of September, we have The Crucible in Orlando by Luminous Gaming. I know a few of us are going. Like I said, I'll be moving around that time, so money's going to be a bit of an issue, so I'm not going to be able to go. But I think, Ben, you said you punched your ticket. You're ready to go.
Yep, I punched my ticket.
Ryan, are you... Yeah.
I'm judging, so I'll be there.
Tim, are you flying from running, New York to Florida like a true New Yorker? Sunday.
Uh-huh. Guaranteed. All right. 100%.
Nice.
Well, I'll be there. I'm going to go to... Hopefully, I'll play... I think I'm playing day one, and then hopefully I lose, and so that way I don't have to play anything else, and I can just go to Universal with my friends. That'd be great.
I think I'm judging day one, so I can make sure that happens.
Thank you.
I got you, Tim.
Service to your friends. I appreciate that. It's the weirdest way to...
Because of the way that airplanes work in Knoxville, because there's only one
direct
flight.
Disqualified.
I have some weird ticket where I leave like on a Friday night, but I don't return as like a Wednesday or Tuesday.
That's
like
what Allegiant does.
Nice.
So I'm taking a couple extra days.
Yeah, that's about right.
Yeah.
But yeah, so it'll be fun. Looking forward to it.
Will, you've not been able to say this in quite some time, but
say,
I think we have.
Say the thing,
say
Will.
Say the words. Say
the
thing.
The news!
I thought you forgot for a second.
All the news! Like, there's news
for everyone. Do you remember the words, Will?
There's
no,
quite
Sam,
a bit of news.
I don't remember strawberries.
But do you remember furberries? God.
I might.
I was a little disappointed that I couldn't be on the last episode because we got Wicket in the last episode. We got to talk about his command cards, which are super cool. And then, we got a little preview of perhaps a Chewbacca inside an AT-ST, which was nice.
And then AMG just decided to drop
the box
whole
art, which is a Weiss. Then it just dropped everything on us. So, oh man, these Ewoks. When it came through the chat, we thought, because we didn't look real close, because it's on our phones, we thought the Ewok skirmishers and the Ewok slingers were also both core.
Ugh.
And we about lost our minds.
Yeah, we about lost our minds.
But the biggest deal is that they are
mercenary
like
for rebels. So even a normal rebel list, you can bring like two slingers as special forces to have just activation padding.
Yeah, you can.
Supposedly, yes.
It's interesting to do as rebels. I think Leia's probably the only place we'll probably
you have to
do
have
this.
A command slot that you,
because to take allies of convenience,
it's
like
that Orlando.
And like,
All right, hard question.
Yeah.
Ewok slingers. Let's talk about what it is first.
Right.
Let's talk about what it is first.
Sure.
It is Special Forces. It is of the Bright Tree faction, but also works as Rebel Mercenaries. It is 35 points. They get you 6 models.
Hell yeah.
They have Independent Surge 1, Low Profile, Target 1, and Unhindered.
Target is super weird.
Well,
from, I don't know.
Because you get
the Surge. Yeah, like getting orders on them is going to be tricky. Like, or that's not the Rebel specialty.
But if you don't, you got the Surge token, which is nice. Because they only have a wide defense die, 1 wound, 1 courage. That's one courage,
Special Forces.
Movement 2. But if you get within range 2, they're throwing a black die for each model that lives.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's fantastico.
It is low profile, too. So you're surviving should be easier.
You should get a couple guys in there.
Yeah.
Exactly. And somehow they get worse if they're in melee because they just throw white dice. But that's really good for 35 points, and it gets a heavy upgrade and a personal upgrade.
And a training.
This was the point cost I was expecting to be on the skirmishers.
So glad it's not.
To be real honest, at 35 points, instead of the 40. So these guys are super tempting. It does eat up a valuable slot, but now if you need another, I think like taking instead of double or triple strike team, you can now take like double strike and a slinger for just some like act padding and objective control, which is nutty.
I'm going to poke the bear on this one. Are Pathfinders better at 56?
Aha, poke the bear.
No, I mean, I would agree, but no one except for Eric is taking like Pathfinders without a heavy.
Pathfinders have lots of options and they surge in places.
Yeah, they're definitely more flexible.
They're more flexible, but I mean, I would bring these guys in a heartbeat just because 6 models, you're probably going to put some other guys on there. So 8 models here.
Yep, 8
are
dudes.
Be scary
just to run around and poke objectives, if nothing else.
mobbing objectives at the end of end of a game, it can be super valuable.
Profile makes it once they start getting suppression stuff on them and cover. Yeah.
I will say it's harder to get cover, but because these aren't droids, you're going to be able to get to just from suppression alone.
It's not hard to get cover these days. Suppression. Not anymore. Not with the rules change.
That's true. That's true. Well, that's very true.
Yeah. And we have seen, and by an uptick, I mean dark troopers with blast. And so I think like sharpshooter 2 and blast weapons are absolutely going to wreck these guys. But no, you are right that just getting able to shrug, hopefully 2 to 3 hits every attack is
but
not.
Do you want to use your big blast or sharpshooter 2 characters into 8 wounds of little Wookiees?
I mean, if you can get 4 or 5 models off the ground, maybe. Absolutely. Like if it clears an Acti.
Because I think if you don't, that's when all the special things are going to come in, and bad for everybody.
When I did the math about if Brighttree has a like 6 core 3 special forces like organization chart, you know, you can just have your 9 units of 8 models running around the table. It'll be a thing.
It's gross.
It's going to be a thing.
I hate it.
And so we don't have the 4-star chart yet. So like weighing these options inside of Rebels is interesting because I don't know that the skirmishers necessarily have a huge place. I definitely think the slingers do.
I definitely think the slingers
are being
do.
Cheaper and yes, absolutely. Not a core slot. Yeah, I think it's interesting.
Yep.
Yeah,
and the way Rebel list building kind of folds down in a lot of ways, you'll usually pick special forces or support. And if you want to bend towards support and get to that 10th or that 11th activation, that's going to be a fantastic way to do it.
And I think part of that is Forest Dwellers. For 3 points, a training that only goes on those guys, and they get Scout 1, and on the first activation, you get a dodge token.
I love this design space. I hope we see more of this in the future where whatever tech your unit is missing and like getting these guys into range, getting these guys in position is what we're missing. So just giving them a dodge at the start of a game is so, so cool. Like, I hope that's something we see more of on more units. It's just like, hey, here's a little boost to help get you into the game if you're not a range 4 gunline fighter. Here's something to help you get started.
Like, this is going to sound super crazy, and then perhaps I'm evil, but if you take the Care Bears and run them through a minefield to get that suppression token...
To activate low profile?
I mean, no, that...
And eat your free dodge? Yeah.
I mean, back in the day when we actually played Rebel Troopers, you would absolutely just take a dodge with a Rebel Trooper and then go step on a mine to clear it for whatever you actually cared about. So I could see sacrificing 0 to 2 teddy bears.
Ken does that, but then doesn't roll the mine correctly, and then now he's got a ticking time bomb of his B1s all exploding.
then it double detonates next time, and kills multiple.
Once he's tried it the third time, it double detonates and kills 8 B1s. Yeah.
Listen, that's a B1 droid problem, but they don't have low profile. Well, suddenly the mines have blasts. Really does great Yeah, but the low profile is going to activate after first activation.
After, after you've been mined, you can dodge harder, I guess.
We talked about Forest Dwellers. We have 4 other cards that they've revealed. The one big surprise, and like I don't know that we necessarily need to go through all of these, although we probably will. There's only 1 heavy weapon option. I am very surprised.
So far, I think they're hiding one. So
I think there's more.
I think they're hiding another
one. You do think they're hiding one? I'd be cool if I truly hope that they are because this is a cool
for
unit
for skirmishers.
But it is you can take it in either one.
Yeah.
Do you want to?
I mean, for the slingers, it's a body. If you just want to get to that 8th model, because right now it's the only thing that goes in that slot. So and it is expensive. 15 points for. It's almost half the cost
unit. We just need to, I like that we have all these cool names for everything, and then for this one, it just says Axe Ewok. did we just give up? Little Bobby with an axe.
He's the Ewok exactly.
He's the same as a Z6 Phase 1 clone.
E11D Delta Stick Club.
Axe Cop. Axe Ewok.
I'm sorry they didn't call it the Myrtleizer Ewok.
I would have been happier with that.
I know.
But for 15 points, you get a red attack die and pierce
in
one
melee.
Speaking of the Myrtleizer, they're going to take the Myrtleizer out.
We'll get to that.
Yeah, that's really it. I mean,
it's interesting that it's our only option, and it's a bit pricier than I would have thought. But I guess if you look at B1s. I mean, we don't have a melee-only B1. How much is the rad cannon 15. B1?
The what? So
that's probably their shortest range. Yeah.
15 now? Yeah.
I can okay. do some research.
Is it 14? It may actually be cheaper, but then I still don't take it, so.
The radiation cannon is the cheapest at 16. Tied with the E5C, which is so much better than it.
So much better.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
If you drop the rad cannon by 6 points, I still wouldn't take it.
So, yeah, the fact that this is a melee only upgrade, it's got good keywords like impact, pierce. It's real good.
Oh, if it gets there, yeah. that's a dead stormtrooper or clone every time it attacks. Yeah.
I mean, you have a good chance of it getting there.
You do. Your speed two unhindered.
Black melee dice plus,
jumping over things.
You're likely going to bring 8. I mean, because that's still not a bad point cost. 65 for eight troopers.
Well, and
if you can get them to survive long.
But what if you could like get them into the fighting range and then they get a free attack after that? That'd be great.
Yeah, imagine if only that. They got charged somehow.
Oh,
but wait!
I'm glad they don't though. I'd be pissed.
Well, you see that training slot there on all your Ewoks?
No.
What if you could take a card called Call to Arms? Ewok trooper only.
Sorry, Tim. PTSD.
Oh, it's Bright Tree trooper only.
Man. Nightmares.
Is that limited to?
Yeah, it's Bright Tree.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you can't give this to anyone.
Damn. You can't have 5
Fleet troopers with this. Yeah.
Well, no. Okay. I'm asking because can you only use it in the Battle Force or can you?
No, it has to be an Ewok unit. So if you look at the Ewok unit cards, they have the little like arrowhead.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Anyways. It is a card that you tap. This unit gains 1 suppression token and then gains charge until the end of the round.
It's pretty cool.
I love it. So it's like, if I murder this unit and now I'm out in the open, at least I get a little bit of low profile.
It's cool that it's not just gains charge. It is an exhaust, so you kind of have to do a little bit of management.
Right. And
it triggers your low profile if you're playing it with the slingers. Or slingers.
And it is unique to 2 per list.
Yeah, that's super cool.
The 2 dots.
Only take it twice.
I think that's cool.
This is the first time we've seen the double dot.
They've been using that a lot in X-Wing. That's neat
that it's not going to be your whole army. Yeah.
Yeah, you can't take
you
can't take 6 skirmishers all with charge.
God. And I don't have enough flamethrowers for that.
To Tim's credit, he is afraid of this thing. It is limited, but you do have the opportunity cost of... If you take it, you don't get Forest Dwellers.
Like, well,
you got to pick one or the other, right?
And you also don't get Insatiable Curiosity.
Well, yes. What if you could get a second training slot?
Oh, that'd be pretty neat, wouldn't it?
And what if if it added a body that lets you use your your giant trap command card?
You mean the lightsaber from the sky that somehow Ewoks have at range 4?
Yes, the Ewok Trapper is here.
Yes.
For 10 points, you add a body
ten points.
Gain a training upgrade slot. And it is the miniature referenced in the log trap command card that you must have draw a line of sight to the target. So
why are you not ever taking, you're always taking
this. Ryan, you mentioned bringing Forest Drillers, which is great. But also there's Insatiable Curiosity. I think you got to think about how you're going to want to kit these guys out, because curiosity is good too. I know we're going to talk about both here in a second, but
we already talked about Dwellers,
we did. That's right.
Well, I want to make one other note on the trapper before we mosey too far.
Yes.
Okay.
Go ahead.
The command card is really objectively for gameplay, it is good. Like shooting a giant dipole from a million miles away with impact and pierce is good. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little disappointed. I would have loved these guys to throw out kind of bane tokens or mines of some kind that lets before the game you get to drop some actual traps and then they're kind of like saboteurs with the detonate keyword.
Having no real ability for the miniature and
a command card, I think is a little boring for what we could have had. Now, who knows?
I mean, it's more mechanics than you get from a normal squad just saying add an extra miniature.
Sure, once again, as the card spread we have, we do not have that option right now.
Yeah. So if this is their generic,
by the way, I want to remind everybody that this is also, remember, Bright Tree gets a 40-point commander in C-3PO who also has Compel.
Yeah, but you're
just to remind everybody,
and you might take C-3PO.
He infiltrates and Compel.
You get a 75-point cocaine bear in Wicket.
And I think you bring Wicket and C-3PO.
That's true. You bring Wicket, but yes.
I imagine they can give us the option.
Well, yeah, but then do you get,
before we go that far along, we need to talk about the big scary card.
Let's talk about the one you're
Insatiable curiosity. Yes, insatiable curiosity, the one I'm more afraid of, the most afraid of.
Yeah, because it touches your upgrade. And the one that bothers me the
most... I think I hate like this design space.
Tim's least favorite thing is picking up models.
it is the worst design space you can have.
Oh, Jesus.
It's the same,
I disagree. But
it is the same space as Din. Of course you do, because you like to be disruptive. So this is the worst design space you could have, because you are taking away someone else's things out of the game. Just not killing it. You're just saying, oh,
Tim,
that thing
before you do your reactions, could you tell them what it does?
Oh, my God. It's just awful. So 8 points, which I do expect a good price. Thank you for 8 points. It's not 5 points. Training slot. So it does take up a training slot. Exhaustible. So it's a one-time use and you're done.
Expendable.
Expend.
Yeah, sure. Whatever. Yeah.
Exhaust is technically
Choose an enemy unit in base contact with this unit's unit leader that has a upgrade on it.
Basically. Heavy weapon, gear, or armament.
Discard one of those non-unique or limited upgrades. This unit suffers one wound.
So you trade an Ewok for their upgrade.
Yep, you trade an Ewok for the upgrade. And it's the mini stays. We should make sure there was some confusion about this online.
There was.
They've been very clear. The mini stays, so you don't lose a body, which is nice. I like it better, which that makes me hate it less.
Yeah, when we were thinking about it, erasing an entire Dark Trooper for 8 points. Just... Walk up.
I know we hate Dark Troopers, but that's still ridiculous. Right. Come on. Like, that's, I understand. Both can be true.
But getting rid of a grenade launcher, B2 or Dark Trooper, or even if you somehow get within close enough range to get rid of the Z6.
What if you
that's really good.
get within range and you touch a Dark Trooper with the crit gun now that's more expensive? I know, spoiler alert.
Just take the assault cannon 55 away.
55 points gone. Oh my God. I hate the space. I hate that space.
I'm going to say, I may very well be wrong. I think people will run this, obviously. I don't think they're going to run it en masse. I don't think every Ewok is going to be taking this, because it's super expensive. It costs you a wound, which for these guys is not insignificant.
I mean,
and a training slot.
And a training slot. And you have to get base to base, which is going to be harder to do than we think. Like, because if you, you know, if I see your clone commander, you go after that linchpin thing. And I think I'm probably going to take one, maybe two copies of this. And I know I'm never going to get to burn them, but it means my Axe Ewoks are going to make the charge, because you have to shoot the curious Ewok before you shoot the other.
Just
stuff.
Run naked Ewoks with curiosity so they have to deal with them.
Yeah, right. Have to make it, what it makes me think of genuinely is from the Two Towers in the Lord of the Rings, like the scene where he's just charging with the gunpowder. It's like, take down that orc, take down that orc, and that's it. It's if I see this guy running towards me, it's everyone just gonna kill him, take him down.
And that's
Legolas.
And that's why I think call to arms. Like, which of these do you give up to get that?
I think you take Forest Dwellers and Curiosity on one unit with no other upgrades and just run them towards them for.
Yeah, and so that's why I think it's not gonna.
Well, and an Ewok trapper.
You need a trapper somewhere.
Maybe just curiosity, like, then. Yeah.
The only place I see this really working out is in not Bright Tree Village, because I will be shocked if you can take an AA5 in Bright Tree Village and just dumping an Ewok to something.
Just having like a medic gun AA5 that also just says, like, here's my unit that takes your upgrades away. Boop.
And then you bring the Ewok back with the medic.
Oh my God.
That would be the waste. That is such a waste of a medic charge to bring an Ewok back.
Well, but your bus medic doesn't have charges, so go nuts.
Yeah, that's true.
I don't think this is going to destroy the game like Tim thinks it is. I think it'll happen.
I didn't say that. I never said that.
I think it'll be.
I said this is a horrible design.
I think
design
you'll
space.
See more of it because they're relatively inexpensive. I think 48 points is nothing. If you pull the special forces and use them as mercenaries, I think 43 points is almost nothing here to pull that off. I guess not a bad place.
I think it's it's so cheap.
And so I think
it's almost as bad as Force Choke.
But again, remember, it's non-unique. Yeah. It's non-unique. So there's certain things you're not going to be able to get rid of. Like, I can't get rid of the Darksaber. Or, you know, Grievous's gun or something like that. It's just going to be on your core units, basically. What other equipment pieces? Am I going to get rid of your jetpacks? Oh no, Cody can't fly. Yeah. Or I guess Rex can't fly. Oh no.
Well, and the other thing about this card is it is definitely better into some lists than others. Because, you know, not a lot of, like, in the Rebel Mirror, not a ton of Rebels take heavy weapons. There's a few lists that do, but it's definitely not the mainstay, and you're going to be targeting more gear options or maybe some armaments. But yeah, against something like Republic or Imperials, it's definitely going to do a lot more work. Because they
I hope so bad that someone runs up to you with an Insatiable Curiosity Ewok and fucking breaks Cassian's gun on you.
Ah, it's unique.
Because it's not unique.
Is it not?
Is it? Double check that.
Okay, that's fine.
Double check that.
Jeez, all right. That'd be...
Oh, wow.
If I let Ewoks get to my Cassian, I deserve to have it to happen. That's fine. I'm cool with that. Good.
Let it happen.
Cassian's got another gun.
So it is not unique.
I want to see a Rebel on Rebel action, and I want to see him break Cass's gun so bad.
I mean, if that happens, I am probably in a bad spot, and I'm going to lose the game anyway.
I agree with you, and I don't argue that, but that still just be very satisfying for me to hear happen.
Okay, sure, Tim. However you get your chuckles, man.
So Jin's blaster is unique, but not the A180 pistol.
Well, that's because Jin's gun can be equipped to two units, so it has to be unique, or else you can bring it on Jin and K2 at the same time.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it'll be interesting. I'm curious to see, I made a pun, where this card will land kind of in the balance of the metagame. Because I think it's one of those big, scary units that it can, in theory, do a whole lot of things. In practice, I don't know how many games are going to swing on it. I don't know. That's just my take.
My bigger thing is not so much the unit itself. It's just we shouldn't encourage that space. I don't think it's a good space to be
we
in.
Have, we talk but about we've like had Force Choke cards. For so long. Like, and Force Choke and does I, the same and, thing.
Okay.
Right. And that's not okay either. Okay. Like, that's...
This is true.
Two wrongs don't make a right.
I railed against the Force Choke.
What, then?
All right. What if my Ewoks run into Bosk and get rid of his targeting skills?
Yay.
Well, Bosk should be dead anyway.
Bosk might actually use his melee profile for once.
I was going to say, Bosk is going to wreck you with his good melee, because he's got a decent melee.
Yeah.
Scoops up four Ewoks at a time, just regenerates.
Because it eats them. Yeah, that's it.
Because it is interesting. It regenerate. Delicious tiny arms and Wookies. Forest dwellers together are the same 8 points. So.
Yeah. No, I think you run a couple of curious Ewoks and then a couple Axe Call to Arm Ewoks and... Have a blast.
It'll be interesting. We'll see. Once again, I think a lot of this hinges on the Force Org.
Right.
Because I don't know that I put Insatiable Curiosity on Slingers. I think they go on Skirmishers.
Right.
And like I said, outside of Bright Tree, I don't know that Skirmishers have a place. But who knows? I could be wrong. I think I would just rather have Troopers.
I think that's true. I think you just bring the Slingers. But yeah. Time will tell. I agree with you, though. I'm curious to see the Force Org. I'd be very curious.
For sure. Are we talking about these command cards, or should I talk about points?
Yes. Yeah, let's talk about command cards. Yeah, let's do Wicket command cards. Well, Wicket's command cards are neat. There's a Leia command card. You guys can talk about Wicket command cards. I have things to say about Leia's command cards.
Yeah, we can run through the command cards
Let's run through the command cards.
Yeah. One pip, close calls for Wicket. Of course, they're all for Wicket. Close call at the start of the activation phase. Wicket gains one dodge token. This round, Wicket increases his maximum speed to 3 and gains outmaneuver.
Burst of speed, Wicket.
He may not make attacks this round. Ooh. So it's getting your Wicket into position.
Yep.
You're getting him there.
Run, little Ewok,
Or getting him out. And I've Ewok art we've seen, this is my favorite by not a small margin.
Him dodging the
ATSD. He should have a supply. Him running, vaulting
over the with his stubby little legs.
Mm-hmm. Should have a picture of him recovering a supply.
Yeah.
That's it. Just running.
Yep.
I mean, you do hate Darth Maul when he grabs that box in GTFOs. Like, this is what I feel close calls about to come. Like,
yeah, I think he's going to go.
Because nothing says the same like Darth Maul and a teddy bear.
Both run away with a box.
Listen, don't denigrate Wicket like that.
No, this card's cool. I think it's safe to say with all of Wicket's cards, I don't think any of them are auto-includes. I think they're all situational with kind of what you want to play with Wicket, because I don't think Wicket's ever going to be your only commander. Like, I think you're going to have probably two commanders, and if you're playing Bright Tree, you get those four Bright Tree cards to pick from.
Yeah. All right, what's the 2-pip? Someone give me the 2-pip.
Sneaky scouting. You give Wicket a command Thanks. You choose up to two enemy units at range 2 of Wicket. They each gain 2 observation tokens. When a friendly unit declares an attack against a unit that has observation tokens this round, they may spend an observation token to get a surge hit for the attack.
Wow, it's better than both of Cody's observation cards. salt.
I do actually like it. But you do have to have Wicket within range.
Yeah, exactly. Stuff. So you play this, you punch somebody, then you play the 1/5 and you run the fuck away.
It's true.
That's really it. It doesn't have to be Wicket. It could be any unit gets close enough.
Right. Well, Wicket already surges. So it could be your slingers who's throwing stuff. I'm pretty sure. So
I mean, it could be your skirmishers who are in there who finally get close enough range to go hit it and then spin it to get the surge.
I just like
having
rebel units that don't surge.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They exist.
Yes, they, it's true.
Yeah, no, I think this is definitely aimed at Rebel Troopers more than Ewoks,
right?
To be perfectly honest. So,
I mean, yeah. And for 70 points, you can afford to run Wicket up there. Independent Dodge 1, low profile and nimble. That's a hell of a combination.
Yeah, no, if you want to play like Rebel Trooper spam, that's not the... And even with the DLT, I think Wicket's going to slot into that list very nicely.
I really do.
Easy has a lot to say tonight.
I really do.
Will, what is the third pip? Tell us.
Wicket's 3 pip, courageous counterattack, orders Wicket and 2 units. And this round, Bright Tree Trooper units with a face-up order token change their courage to dash.
That's
so good.
When a Bright Tree Village Trooper...
Yeah, there's a period there.
When a Bright Tree Village Trooper unit that has a face-up order token forms an attack pool... Add 1 white die to the attack pool for every wound token or defeated miniature in the unit. Last stand, but better.
So yeah, can you imagine that one final guy, you got one little mini left, and he's like...
One miniature does a melee attack with...
Looks like I'm throwing 6 dice anyway. Yeah.
One black, 7 white. Cool. And he's Bravery Dash.
We're promoting this unit leader, who formerly named as Rug.
Yeah, this card is super cool.
Yeah, I like Wicket's cards.
Yeah.
For how cheap he is, I'm glad he doesn't have some like obnoxious double attack melee giant card. You know, these are fun little sport cards, and then close call.
Yeah, the fact that his 1 pip is the exact opposite. Instead of gaining an extra attack, it's you don't get an attack. I am a Jedi myself. It's cool.
I am a coward. Bye.
All right. So I can already see where doubles play. This is going to
be for sure.
Let's just...
And as the unofficial pope of doubles, I am very glad we have the rule in place that...
I never saw the white smoke. You were not appointed.
One battle force.
Yeah, I don't know where that title came from, but all right. That's...
Hey, my doubles event have been run in like 5 countries now, so I'll take it. We're internationally represented. Listen,
just because King Henry VIII wanted it doesn't mean it made it happen, all right? I'm just saying.
You're the Avignon papacy of teams events.
Who's the other one, then?
Nice deep pool.
Wouldn't you like to know?
Nice.
I mean, AMG doesn't even have the... Like, the doubles rules aren't even in the rule book anymore.
That's because we're supposed to be playing Spec Ops. But no one cares.
We're not talking about Spec Ops. Please, Ryan, tell us about the beautiful friendship.
Or you can play Shatterpoint. Would you like more Shatterpoint?
Beautiful friendship. This is a Leia
on a week that we don't have content? Yes, I would like more Shatterpoint, but we have content. So.
We never
have Leia 2-pip. Wicket and Leia both get orders. This card is... The only downside of this card is the fact that it competes with a very competitive 2-pip slot for Leia. It's the first time Rebels have gotten a permanent command card. We're permanent.
Welcome Wicket to the club.
Gains teamwork, Leia Organa.
God, you've done that it. Is gross.
That is, oh my goodness.
Oh my god. I mean, I don't like this at all.
That's good and that's bad. I think that's good for the early turns. Wicket is quickly, I think, going to run more than range 2 away from Leia, probably pretty quickly. But for the early turns to spool him up, it's probably pretty solid and doesn't help get him out of jail. Yes, but. Teamwork really works at range 2.
So moving on.
So I think he's going to run away. Leia tends to stay and hide.
But the sauce is when an Ewok commander issues an order, you may choose a friendly rebel unit at range one and issue it an order. When a rebel issues an order, you may choose a friendly Ewok unit at range one and issue it an order. That is, for the faction that struggles with order control, that is nutty. Absolutely nutty. And it's not Bright Tree only. So if you just wanted to splash Wicket into your Force Org and then take some cool, like Rebel Operatives, it's not like we don't have any of those that are really awesome, and taking Wicket and Leia as commanders and then a couple Ewoks to splash around, that's zesty.
I can see this being very mercenary. Like, you just bring in Ewoks as mercenaries could really, it's going to definitely, I think, change up.
Yeah, level you give the order to Fives, and the Fives will relay it on to another unit, and then you're good. Ha-ha!
An interesting point, Wicket's loadout is just three trainings, which is hilarious that he has three, but he means he can't take allies' convenience himself.
Right.
So that is one downside, but Leia's got two slots, so who cares? This card is nutty.
Hear me out. So, spoiler alerts, we've talked about it all episode. We know there's been point changes. Leia is now 75 points.
Yeah, she is.
So Wicket's only 70. Mm-hmm. I think I run both of them up there. I mean, she's got three black dice, pierce one, sharpshooter two, and
she's got a good shot. Yeah.
She's got a good melee. I think the two of them run tag team and be like, you know what? Let's fuck this planet up and just go.
I bet you this. And I have no...
It's the other guys.
I have no insider knowledge on this, so I don't know. I'm just guessing. I bet you the Force Org chart lets you bring at least three commanders.
I would probably say that's probably pretty safe, yeah.
Because think about, like, Echo Base and, like, where everybody... not Echo Base. Sorry. Endor Base, where everyone's at, and, you know, there's all nothing but character spam down there in episode 6.
Yeah, the other thing is there's another Ewok commander that we have not seen yet.
Yeah.
We saw Gray. We saw a glimpse of him. Yeah.
I don't know. I need to look. An operative? I don't know if he's going to come with command cards. I think the Wicket box comes with seven command cards, or maybe it's eight. It's these four and then the Bright Tree cards. I don't know that there's going to be unique command cards for whatever he does, but maybe he's just a 40-point, like, generic Ewok commander, or unique but generic, you know, doesn't come with cool cards. Who knows?
Like the Wookiee Chieftain kind of thing.
Yeah, exactly. So, who knows? But yeah, no, Beautiful Friendship is going to be nutty. I do think Bright Tree will probably let you bring a bunch of characters, because we do have Wicket and Han and C-3PO and Leia. So,
yeah, it'll be interesting.
Chewbacca.
Every Battle Force so far has had that, like, unique upgrades allowed, and there's been, like, two cards. This is probably going to be the one where there's, like, five or six that are allowed, like, units and cards and... I'm curious how many rebel units will be allowed into it.
I think it'll be pretty restrictive on the rebel side of things. You know, probably just rebel troopers.
Yeah.
And commandos.
But like characters allowed.
Yo, characters, I think this will be or structured more similar to Shadow Collective, where you're just like, you know, take four commanders or operatives as long as one's a commander, but you have a very low core requirement, although you're going to want to take a bunch of core because you want a bunch of Ewoks.
It'd be interesting if they capped the core to, like, three to make it more, like, where you have to spend points up elsewhere so you can't just bring nine units of eight Ewoks.
Sure.
But then also
and there may be a requirement that you have to take some amount of Rebel Troopers, too.
Yeah.
Because we do see
or
them.
Or, like, you have to pay for, like, Rebel Commandos either.
Sure. I don't know that that'll be a requirement. Tim. Maybe. Well, sorry, go ahead, Ben.
Yes.
I was going to say, Tim, how do you murder these Care Bears? How do you personally murder these Care Bears?
Genuinely, I'm not even joking, probably flamethrowers.
Yes.
Probably flamethrowers, because you want to get close, that's fine. I got things for close.
And you can't even scratch the armor.
I do want to see some snowtroopers go in and... you can't scratch primitive. The
armor. So. AT-RTs are immune to Ewoks. Fawoosh.
Exactly. That's right.
I mean, Spider Joid flamethrowers may make a comeback.
If they ever fix Creature Troopers rules, I'll bring those dewbacks back for those flamers.
Oh, God, they have a flamer.
Yeah, which also got cheaper as well, but yeah.
Tim's out there just deforesting the planet.
Fixed Creature Troopers rules. Are you just mad that they don't provide cover anymore?
No. Well, that's one thing. Okay. One thing of many. You can't bounce in between out of melee into or engagement to melee and such and such. Basically, relentless withdrawal means next to nothing now.
I mean, As a Tauntaun player, that's probably a really good thing.
What's the point of bringing a creature trooper then? Like, why am I going to bother? Also, it's taller now, so anything, like, it's harder to get cover when everything else is taller too, so you're getting shot over all the terrain.
Yeah, it's a blessing. It's just blessing and a curse.
Okay, sure.
You can see over a lot of things, yeah.
Tauntauns are much better than Dubecks, though.
Yep, also true.
Well, yeah, and they're also much more expensive.
They really are.
Yeah.
But and not much more, but okay.
Well, you know, we seem to be talking a lot about what things cost.
Yeah, let's talk about points.
15 points now, probably, but yeah.
And today, AMG.
But guys, it's happening.
AMG
it's
dropped
happening.
A hot load of content on us just before we recorded.
Yeah, about an hour.
All over our faces.
God, it was so good.
Tim's tongue was out. It was all written.
It was. I wasn't ready.
He said, ooh, woo.
I wasn't ready.
There's at least three or four things to talk about on this list.
Yeah,
there's at least a couple.
This is an interesting list of point changes.
Most important change in the Empire, Tim, is it Kallus?
Your boy Kallus? Your world's Kallus, appearance?
Kallus came down Kallus? A bunch because he
Kallus
went negative
came down
five.
A bunch, yeah.
But right. Then also negative 10 on his bow rifle. So let's, yeah, maybe.
But he needed it. He's so
Kallus double bounty is was already good, though.
Yeah, so I think now, Kallus people were sleeping gonna, on. Yeah.
Do we want to go through each faction and what they changed, or do we just want to randomly react to things?
Yes, please.
Okay.
No, let's just run down. Because if we run down the list.
Tim, go through the Empire changes.
All right, so we can run down the list. Kallus, I'm going to throw his bow rifle in there with him too. Kallus and his bow rifle, down points. Kallus down 5, bow rifle down 10, so down 15. Because you're going to bring the bow rifle even before the points drop.
Oh, you should need to,
Freaking bringing that rifle, yeah.
So an Ewok can break it.
Again, I think he's actually got some play. 90, so
90 points equipped.
That's bananas.
That's Kallus. That is wild. Really,
yeah, so good. It's what he should have been, honestly. But anyway.
It's what he should have been.
Because it was ridiculously overcosted. But anyway, Eweb down 5 points. Neat. We still can't shoot at range 4. Still a dead unit. That's it.
Is why I'm letting Tim go first. Just
I hate
let
that
him
for
finish.
Eweb, but I agree.
Just let him finish. Veers,
I agree with Tim on the Eweb.
Veers down
5.
I actually don't agree with that because I think we should have kept him up here because he can go into Blizzard Force. So
yep, I agree.
But whatever. I get he wasn't seeing a lot of play. I like Veers. I still think he should have stayed where he was.
But Becky.
Imp Officer. I like him at 70. Imp Officer up 5, which is in response to Blizzard. So up to 50 now.
Yep, that's exactly what that is.
Which is fine. Storm HRU, this is arguably the big one, or one of the big ones. The HRU for Blizzard Force is up 10 points, which remember, kids, you can only bring 2 of them in Blizzard, so your Blizzard got bumped up 20 points.
Right.
So that's good. Probably 25 at least, because most people are bringing Officer. Sometimes they don't, but most times you bring an Officer. So there's 25 points. I'm just going to throw it in here. Force Choke also went up by 5 points, so up to 10. So now you're looking at most Blizzard lists went up 25 to 30 points.
Which is good.
It's good. I don't think it was quite enough, but I think it's a good
start.
That
was almost their bid.
I think it's not that bad, but I think it's almost enough. We're close. I appreciate them. I'd like one more update with a little bit more of a bump or some rules changes. But anyway.
Right.
Dual-back flamethrower down 5 points. So it's down to 10, which is great. It's overcosted. Yep. Dubek RT, this one was nuts to me. The RT-97 went down 5
I
more
can't
points.
Believe,
That's wild.
So that's what?
So it's only 5 points five now. Points? So for 75 points, you get a Dubek that has range a fantastic 4. Melee and then a really nice range 4.
That's
I mean, that range 3 crit gun is good, but like that range 4, that means you're not forced to get close.
I think you can honestly just put 2 of these, like one on each flank and just kind of like micro move relentless shoot and then micro move back.
There's a discussion to be had for even though they're not the fire support faction, you could fire support some shots off of Dubecks.
Yeah.
Either from darks or from mortars. You know, if you're using the Gideon card for the special.
Yeah, I was going to say the Gideon.
Well, even just with the mortar, that gives it critical, 2 now?
Yeah.
So
critical 1.
Well, doesn't critical. The RT have crit baked in?
No, the RT is range 4. The range 3 gun is range
4.
Anyway, so very interesting. I still think creature trooper rules are a problem, but at least it's a step in the right direction. And then the other big ones, frag launcher for the dark trooper up 5 points, assault cannon up 7 points, which is good.
Yeah.
I think they had
to. I don't know if it was enough.
We'll find out.
I agree with that. I agree with that, but I think it's a brand new unit. Let's start somewhere. Like,
so
we don't want to
the way people have been
out.
Building it, they went up 12 points. I think so you have 24, to reorganize 20? Your lists, but I don't think you, like, if you're playing darks, I don't think you completely change your list. I don't know that it's enough to bump them out of your list. I think here's you just the cut thing. A here's heavy weapon somewhere else.
But I think that's the thing, though. That's the difference between Blizzard and, like, Dark Trooper list for me, is that Dark Troopers, I see them always getting really close to that point total. Like, they're getting 795, 799, like, 800.
Sure.
Like, the guy I played this weekend, these double Dark list, IRG, he was right at 800. We were both at 800. We rolled for it.
Yeah, but I think it's a no-brainer to keep your Darks as is and just cut, like, a T21 off something else.
So but, that's
so you're cutting the T21 off of a shore.
That's losing huge. Something, yeah.
That's huge.
Yeah,
that's
yeah but
to cut that off a shore?
It's not nothing.
For
is
four
it enough?
Red we'll armor see. Saves? It's. I think it's a worthy cut.
Four red armor saves and impact
an
heavy
to
meta?
Empower the Myrtleizer.
Empower yeah, the well, no, and we were talking about yeah. this before the show. I think what it becomes is you drop the frag launcher that half the time when you were shooting, it was cycling, so you weren't using it anyway, or you were at range 3. And I think you just take the Myrtleizer and they can still use the main Dark Trooper gun. And I think it's only a 2-point increase from what the old frag assault cannon was to the new right. assault cannon plus Myrtleizer. So I think
but it's still
I
2 points.
Yeah, well, I think the frag just goes away.
All I'm saying is a lot of the lists I've seen, they don't have a lot of fat to cut because Dark Troopers are so expensive, and rightfully so.
Yeah.
Rightfully so. But there's not a lot of fat to trim. Blizzard has the fat to trim.
Yeah, because they had like a 13 to 15 point bid and four comms on the bikes that you can just
and it's, get again, out especially the way. In a yeah. world where there's a lot of impact already, and now we're going to see even more impact probably with the cheaper units.
Yep.
I'd be a little scared if I was a Dark Trooper player.
All right. Well, so to that point, there's a lot of impact units. They're the reason there's a lot of impact units, though. And so if darks got hit harder and were forced away more, their survivability in theory would go up because if there's less common, less impact is being brought. Does that make sense?
In theory. Like,
potentially. Yeah. In theory, yeah. There's yeah. a lot of theory
that's
crafting.
That's a long-term kind of response, though, where you're like, now that darks are out of meta, I can play them and no one will have impact for them. Ha-ha-ha. I don't, you know, that's so, very...
There's a lot of gambling going on.
We had
on.
Impacts yeah. before yeah. before darks. We did. We had lots of impact before darks. We started this game with impacts.
Well, that's because it was the one keyword that existed.
This is true. This is very true.
But vehicles have always been a thing.
I guess what I'm trying to get at is that we've had units like, yeah, vehicles have always been a thing. And I just think this means that the AT-RT for Rebels just loses more.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Because there's going to be so much impact. And that frame.
No, AT-RT has been gone for a long time. Yeah. But and I would say that is true probably for a lot of the Rebel heavies, just because we don't have a red safe heavy. That until darks like kind of go away, it's very difficult to be a rebel heavy. That's not like a super utility
Airspeeder.
Piece.
Airspeeder is still really good.
They die.
They just die. There's maybe. 7 wounds on a white save.
They can
with
melt
all the impact
easy.
Floating and critical, they just melt. Yeah. I fought real hard about bringing them right to Worlds, and then when I saw Dark Troopers and people's response to Dark Troopers, I was like, there's no way I'm bringing Airspeeders, because they're just going to die accidentally. It's not people teched for them. They're just like, oh, whatever kills the meta thing also kills this thing. That's neat.
They're also very difficult to like hide effectively. Like if you want to, like there's not a lot of terrain tall enough to really hide them behind.
Yep. And they're only range 3, so if I'm doing anything effective, most of the impact weapons, except for the other Rebel ones, are longer range or the same range, so I can't really, like, snipe at the fringe and at the edges. So, no, Airspeeders themselves are in a good place. They're a strong unit, but just this meta is not a great time for them. But I would have liked to have seen Darks get hit a little bit harder.
I agree. I think Blizzard and Dark should have been hit a little bit more. Just a little bit.
Yeah,
I would honestly like to see Darks hit less in the points department, because they are super expensive, and just the way some of their keyword interactions, I think. But once again,
I agree.
Who knows?
I agree.
Yeah, it'd be nice if they couldn't be Guardianed.
Or no Guardian, and I would argue they shouldn't count for objectives, but that's just me.
Be interesting.
Yeah, I've heard lots of cool theories on how to balance them out. Though the one that I particularly like is they have 2 activation tokens, make them count as 2 heavies for your Force Org. And so that way, if you want to bring double, you have to bring Gideon. Like, it's not that you pull it off the table. You just kind of put a requirement, another expense, like 100 plus point unit behind it. So it dictates your list.
Well, Ryan.
And it's
so,
yes.
Why don't you run through your rebel changes?
Well, these numbers, in a surprise to absolutely no one, are all negative point costs.
And you have the highest number of affected units, I think.
Yeah, after getting touches in the last update.
That's true.
Rebels are in a hard spot. It's true, yeah.
Yep. Statistically,
they never get any love. Just nothing. No love.
They definitely didn't get the most recent character release.
No, that's true.
Yeah.
I mean,
awful.
And they definitely aren't getting any kind of
nothing.
God, I can't believe how much they hate Rebels.
Zero content. Ryan,
tell us about how much they hate Rebels.
These changes are weird. Can we at least agree on that? That some of these changes we were expecting.
Not really, but okay.
Okay.
They seem to have flipped a coin on what they tested and what they didn't. Yeah. I agree.
Yeah, yeah. Like, so we got Mandos.
I agree with all the changes we have. Let's say that.
Yes.
The Mando changes are cool. All the Mandos came down between... Four points for upgrades.
Yeah, they're all 4 points.
4 points on units. So probably about 8 to 10 points overall.
Yeah.
Which kind of helps balance out the fact that all the trainings that they needed went up in the last update.
Right.
So,
I mean, your clan ran down 12 points from base. I mean, just.
So, in a sense, I kind of feel like they're in the same spot they were in last November. Like, they're kind of back there, which they still weren't.
All right, so they get vigilance again.
Well, yeah. But they weren't seeing play really then either. So, I don't know that this was enough.
Okay.
We'll see. What else got touched?
So now you're basically vigilance free. I mean,
yeah, you're getting up close and personal back onto them, or you're getting a vigilance, or, you know, you're getting something back. I think probably the biggest change is the fact that Beskad came down.
Yeah.
He's a pretty... I think he's the only thing that holds Mandalorian resistance together. So we'll see if they hit the table. Down. Yeah.
Your inferior rockets.
Yeah. I still don't love the rockets on them. Maybe in a Dark Trooper meta, we really need them.
In the four-man squad, they're okay.
Yeah. The fact that ours can't be shot at any range like the Shadow Collective's can is
that is yeah
tricky.
Tricky is a word for it.
Luke and Lando went down 10. Definitely needed to happen because Lando.
There was no Lando.
I
think he could go down another 5 and still be okay.
he's got a scary weapon. He really does.
It's two dice.
Two dice at
range 3. Well,
sharp 2.
It'll kill one model a turn. So
if you want to take, it makes him easier to throw into like a hero hammer list, which is where you want him for his contingencies. So maybe
I think you're still paying for the contingencies. Yeah. That's why it can't be 90. I think you're still paying for the contingencies.
Well, he's 90. Yeah, I don't know. We'll see.
That's why he's 95. I think you go to 90. Like I think you're getting
because once again, a lot of the upgrades he took back in December, November also went up. So I feel like he's kind of back where he was. Commander Luke down 10. Does Commander Luke see play? I don't know.
I don't know. I've not seen him in so long. I forget what he does.
I hear stories of Rebel lists that do bring him as like a one time. Whack-a-mole kind of thing.
I mean, he's access to some cool command cards, but...
It's Master of the Force. That's the problem you guys have with him. He doesn't have Master of the Force. So he's at 150 right now.
It's the fact that he doesn't have Master of the Force and all of the Jedi... Yeah, exactly. All the Jedi that don't have Master of the Force have some kind of refresh ability, and he only has that in Echo Base. And that eats one of Echo Base's orders that you really want to be putting on core to get those fire supports rolling. So, the big one, the thing that makes me happy, Tauntaun's down 5.
Woo.
That's great.
Didn't need to happen.
You just went on a tirade on how creature troopers are bad.
Yeah, but Tauntauns are good.
Oh, no, that is mostly just Dupex.
By creature troopers, he means Dupex. No.
So does that put them at 85 points?
No, that puts
them
back to printed cost at 90.
Okay.
So I think they could have come down to 85 and been okay.
You're nuts.
No, the rules update for a different reason than Dewbacks hit Tawns in a weird way. They don't provide cover anymore. And in the crappy defense faction, like just screening with them, letting them provide a little bit of cover, or you have to shoot the Tawns with
crappy high defense wounds. Faction?
Yes.
You okay, okay.
You have also nimble.
But
also
we don't have ways to generate those tokens. That's the issue.
Leia.
This one, the Andor's gun, down 10 points. That's wild to me.
Yeah, I don't understand where that's one. Coming from, but okay.
I mean, I'm not mad about it.
Yeah, I don't know that, but okay. Yeah,
He was one of the best Rebel commanders, like just so points for pound out there. So the fact that all my Cassian K2 lists went down 10 points, right? I'm not mad about it.
Yeah.
Well, maybe that was their argument for it. Maybe that's the justification.
Then X-34.
Yeah, this. So between Worlds, Cherokee, and Rocky Top, I think the Rebel heavy of choice lately, and a lot of this is coming out of the Indiana guys, has been the X-34, and they've been doing tricky, cool stuff with it.
Mm-hmm.
And it did not get cut. All of its offensive capabilities did.
Well, so that way it's not just a cheaper taxi for characters.
Yeah.
It's not like a 40-point
right.
open transport. So,
well,
the ion guns.
But the rocket launcher still.
It's 21 now, I think, which is not awful.
Yeah.
Like, because it was ungodly expensive for a very long time.
Yeah, those upgrades came out and they were way too high printed costs. Like the guy with two white dice being like 8 or 9 points or whatever he was.
Well, and the other interesting thing that's happened in that is we got the bus.
Right.
And the bus came with the Gonk and the Unstable, which are arguably better on the X-34. And so now you're competing with those slots.
Right.
So the RPS rocket went away because why would I want a rocket launcher when I could just shoot my hood gun twice?
Right.
For, you know, literally a quarter of the cost. So this makes it... It's not definitely not an auto include, but it makes it a decision. Yeah, the ion gun coming down 6 points is huge. It's only 25 now. That was 38 points when it was released.
God, was it really?
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh my God,
they were all crazy.
Yeah. Yeah,
I just
and the Mark II was 34 points, and it's down to 21. So I think if you want to run a gunboat, like now's the time to do it. But once again, we just talked about how there's impact everywhere, so. You're to get this extra offense, especially in the rocket gunner form, you're going to have to sacrifice some defense in the Gonk droid or you're taking the astromech to blow yourself up faster. So it's interesting. Interesting set of choices.
The one time unstable astromech suicide run is a scary thing.
Yeah. So this is the set of changes I really don't understand because the Cassian and then the land speeder getting cheaper. We'll talk about it here, but it also matters for mercenaries. The AA-5's quad laser gun, the big gun, went down 3 points, which I think is fine.
It's a thing?
Neat. I think it's neat.
Yeah, cool.
It was a little overcosted.
Sure.
for the faction that couldn't get the frenzied gunner.
Right.
So it's, neat. Well, it's making impact cheaper.
Which seems to be a philosophy.
Then, yeah. And then the SX-21 for the Rebel Trooper, no one asked for it, but it came down 2 points. It was already 15. It's been cut and cut and cut again, and now it's two.
Isn't that the Rebel meta for Rocky Top, though?
There was Matt from Indiana did well with it. I think I won the Dice Head event before COVID was the last time I used one.
You were like in love with them when they were announced.
They were so much fun, but yeah, now
it's true.
Critical's a thing, and range 4 is much more prevalent. So range 2 weapons are a lot harder to make function. So we'll see if they make a resurgence. I don't know. Maybe. That's neat. Weird Rebel changes. Nothing for Wookiees, nothing for RTs, nothing for Paths, which are units Randos? I thought struggled a little bit more.
Again, it seems they only tested certain units and then brought those down, which is warranted, but there's still some units that need love.
Those Mandos needed some love.
Yeah.
Well, and that's why I'm not sure this was enough, because for Tauntauns, Leia, Lando to a lesser degree, and the Mandos, I think this just puts them back where they were in November. And they weren't seeing a ton of play then either.
I think it puts the Mandos in a better spot. Not like overpowered, but like I think they're in a good spot now. But
it's a decent choice.
I think they got a little bit of a leg up. Yeah, they got a little bit of a leg up from where they were.
Yeah.
And I'll be honest, Rebel Troopers with the SX gun and the Rebel Trooper Specialist is only 61
points.
That's
not bad.
That's six bodies with the ability to grab a dodge when you need it to keep them nimble to get them close enough to get them to range two, and that's a lot of dice.
I mean, courage for them is the short range units is the problem, and so I think you have to take Leia. Maybe Ahsoka's Inspire card is enough to get you there.
But Leia's 70 points.
And so, like I said, maybe there's something there, but running face first into a gun line and dark troopers to get to range two is problematic.
Sometimes you have to sacrifice.
To get that impact two, and I get to kill maybe one dark trooper mini. And
Ben
now
Marshall Zukov Fowler. Pick up the rifle from the man in front.
So we'll see. We'll see. I think... this is not all the changes I was expecting. I think it's a good start. We're definitely in a better place. My worlds list came down 20 points, so obviously I'm happy.
You don't sound happy.
But I just feel like we're back to where we were in November.
This is the happy voice.
This is the happy.
Yeah, this is.
This is the happy rebels.
I want to play ATRTs. I love ATRTs.
They're
I haven't
mine
gotten
now.
To play them since
play clones.
Yes, since LVO, like ours. Three
ours
LVOs
now,
ago.
Yes.
Don't you lump me in with you.
Right. So... speaking of people that have never been happy on the Legion Discord, we have to get to the Grand Army.
Yeah, those people are never happy. Because that's true.
I'm here to be the thankful Republic player.
That's true. You are.
I'm also thankful, but okay. Yeah.
You're not a Republic player. Go away.
I am some days.
Yeah, get your droid army out next. Why don't you?
But I mean,
okay.
Like, this is all the jank that I love in Gar. It's all the stuff that I enjoy in Gar that
yes.
no one likes to play.
Listeners, so we've made it through the two salt yeah. zones. Welcome to me and Ben's fun corner, starting with the Republic.
Fun.
Full arc fun. Troopers, down 6 points. Jesus Christ.
Solid. Thank great.
You. Yeah, that seems
501st is back on the menu, boys.
Oh, yes, it that's, is.
That's and by back, that's I mean dashes. On the menu.
It was always on the menu. Yeah.
Rex also down 5.
I think they had to look at that and realize, oh, this is dead. And
well, this is their second points drop in a row, so yeah, they're still
Rex.
Yeah. Rex down 5.
Rex is not a it's not a point problem for him still, but all right, cool.
It helps. It you know it helps.
It does.
It does help. For
our
sure,
our
for
one.
Sure. Does this mean I can put rockets on him for free?
Yeah, his jetpack's 5. So yeah.
Yeah.
The least effectual change. Republic Lat down 5.
No one cares.
No one cares. Play Empire Lat if you're going to.
I was shocked to realize that it was at 105 before. I didn't realize that.
Oh, it's so bad.
And it wasn't 120.
Arc Lat drop is cool, like getting them up like turn one into range two. So that coming down effectively 11 points is neat.
And there's the it's enough. There's the guy that hands out Observe 4 every turn from it.
Yeah.
So it's neat.
As a turn. Yeah. It takes an action.
Yeah, ugh, so you observe anyway, 4 and you action. Shoot. That's your turns.
That's right.
I think it's the ability for hover is why they're afraid to bring any lower, because you can just drop units in bad places if you get too much cheaper. If it hits like 90
Never,
points,
I mean,
I think that.
I saw the double lat triple flutter Air Force list dropping shotguns on people's deployment zones.
Man. I love it, but also feel that person.
They had a pilot's cap and goggles on and played Flight of the Valkyries.
Sir, you've been hurt by somebody, and we need to get
this.
Talk
is
about
not
this
therapy, sir. This doesn't count. No,
I do have to mention something awesome that I failed to mention about Rocky Top.
Oh, okay.
We did have a player bring triple flutters to Rocky Top, go 3-2, and score 0 objective points on the weekend.
Well,
and
he
it was
might
amazing.
Be excited.
I'm so glad you remember that story.
And also ill.
That guy, bravo.
That
is the most stab-tastic.
You really, yeah. At the, he realized he was losing game 5, so hard. And he's on KP, and he's just like, I'm going to lose the middle point. So he just gets all of his guys off of his safe KP so he doesn't sully his 0 VP record.
He and Brett should be best friends.
That's impressive, yeah.
They both have the spirit. Padme, also down 5. Neat.
Woo-hoo.
That's huge. I actually think that's a pretty big deal.
That needed to happen.
Ever since they lost the standby thing and their relevance because of it. Yeah.
So Anakin and her have now both gotten a points cut as 2 exemplar units.
Yeah.
And I think that kind of is the light diet fix to like unlimited clone sharing. So
it can be.
You're getting that back, and it's a little bit easier to access.
All that anyone cared about was standbys, though.
Yeah, you're right. But
I mean, and her ability to be authoritative and give her command token away. I mean, she's
speaking of previous
85 points.
Speaking of previous boogeymen, the saber tank. Used to be the Yoda Padme Saber Nightmare.
Yeah,
my baby.
It's down 10.
Yes, I do remember
that's,
the days.
Yeah.
Solid. That's good.
And pretty the beam cannon loses...
160?
Goes down by 25 points because they finally realized it's terrible.
It's still bad.
It's still so bad.
Was it 25 or 15? Because it says the card is 30.
Okay.
But didn't it go up at one point?
I don't think
no,
it
No, you're right. It was 30. Okay. I thought it was 40, but you're right. It was 30.
I thought it was 40 as well. I pulled something up before and it said the wrong total then. But anyway.
Yeah, so 15. It now costs 15, which the twin laser still costs 14. So why are you bringing the
beam? Yeah.
You're still not going to bring it.
It's still not happening.
I want to suppress everything.
No.
I guess.
Maybe. Then use an ISP.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm sure there's a way that... that Brett or someone will worm their way to make Beam better and work. But then I think an ISP just does it better.
Exactly.
Before we get to my swamp boat of love.
For a much cheaper.
The NASP Gunner, which is the bowcaster one, went down
this
by 10.
This is actually pretty... That's,
this,
so
yeah, that's pretty
impact pierce. If you want to spam impact pierce on flyers...
It need to come down. It was much too expensive.
It's red, black, though.
Yeah, search hit.
Pierce one.
If
that's
you can
find
a way to keep them alive, they're really good.
There's you can fly them in a way they never move. Like
basically.
Yeah, they go in like a circle.
You just reposition, move, and you always have your ass towards the enemy to shoot them with your little gunner.
Yeah, but I think the way that you have to, I don't know, the only way I've seen them flown well is you create a deployment where you've got a big flank, and then it's like dart in, use reposition to shoot, and then fly away with your compulsory. Sure. So you're always outside of range 3.
There are ways to do it.
It basically makes it a 70-point unit.
Yeah. Which is in line with most of the other support costs.
To shoot at your behind.
Yep.
It used to be the most expensive support, so I'm glad it's not.
Absolutely.
Yes. And then finally, my swamp boats. Mm. All of the weapons for the ISP have gone down from 40 to 25.
It needed
which basically means the ISP got a 15-point cut. You're never taking it without a weapon.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm going to be moaning for the next half hour.
Yeah.
And rightfully so.
Yeah. That, once again, a cut I was not expecting. I was expecting
AMG.
the core to come down.
No, they don't
and
need
maybe,
to.
Yeah. But I like the fact that they're encouraging you to do other things than just fire support spam heavy weapons.
Well, the whole point is that the things around your fire
support. Well, now
support
you still
core, will. Yeah. The things around your fire support are gotten cheaper. So, like, the list that I won the Knoxville League with has gone down by 30 points. So
that's wild. Yeah.
Yeah.
And still has double flamer, still has 10 activations. I could maybe get it to 11 now.
So we can't pack up all of our impact yet.
Nope.
It's just not for dark troopers.
So what this
anymore.
Tells me is we need slightly higher terrain.
Don't you fucking do it.
Because that's
don't you start that. We just got allowed to go over it now with the changes.
We're just
going to
take some moving boxes, that kind of corrugated cardboard with a little bit of like air gap in it, and just put a footprint of all of our terrain to raise it up by that sixth of an inch.
I hate all of you.
Because, I mean, I've watched Will put that thing on top of a building, knowing that it will never move again, because that was the most advantageous
spot to
shoot from.
It's a range 4 red missile attack.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Sometimes you just got to sit up there and take it.
Sometimes you have to be like,
I did it versus Michael Henry.
I do. Still because lost. That is the only downside of the ISP, is it is so short. Yeah. It is so difficult for it to move
it
over.
It is the downside.
But it's a little bit easier now, a little bit easier with the change.
No, it's the same.
Like, it's not perfect. No, wasn't it? It used to be half the height, wasn't it?
Repulsors, it was always full height. Your tank got better.
Oh, I always forget.
It was the tank and the snail that were half height and really suffered for it.
Yeah. I always forget it's repulsor.
You got brought to my world of height.
But I mean, I'm surprised. Maybe because Cody's dropping, and they realize people booed Cody, so they just changed.
Like a lot of Cody lists got indirectly buffed because all of the things all saber he changes, with the exception of the RT.
I think Cody saber is good.
Yeah, I do too.
Yeah.
Yes. So, please stop talking about it.
If you want to keep trying double saber,
hold on, we're not. I know you're a part of the Scoundrels where you don't talk about the list you're going to bring, so people don't think about it. But we give away our secrets here.
Says the guy that said we couldn't talk about an interaction with Leia's 2-pip beautiful friendship, right. So you don't want it spoiled to the public.
Yeah, because I want to break it in a tournament. Fine, I'm sure it's already been FAQ'd.
It only works in a mirror. Right, it doesn't even. Okay.
It doesn't. It's
Ben
bad.
Droids. What?
Speaking of bad things, droids.
Man. Look, sir, droids.
We're having all sorts of fun in Droidville.
I don't want to
I have
to complain
bitterly that the BXs were overcosted. I mean, but now we're fixing that. BXs are down 4 points for a full unit, which I love. The BX shields are down 8 because they were 16. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that's a really nice place to be. So, I mean, so droid commandos, that puts us at, 64 points, which is not a bad place.
No, for a red save impervious, scouting, like... Their AI is still a little bit problematic, but I think they're in a good spot, and I'm glad it wasn't the strike teams. I'm glad it was just the full guys.
Yeah. But just like arcs.
I mean, so the shields are now 10, so if I'm going to put, an actual sniper on them, it doesn't feel quite as bad to get those extra wounds coming out of that. The Dioxys mine is still stupid and overcosted. That was not adjusted. I don't understand why, but there it is.
Yeah.
The real secret to all my joy has got to be Dooku.
Yes.
Really?
You've never played Dooku.
Oh, man.
I mean, I was going to say, you're bad at Dooku.
I know. I know, wrong. There's lots of more joy here, but Dooku, half my problem is he's incredibly expensive. And so for him to come down 10 full points is a
that
lot.
Also
that
means,
puts him at 185.
That means Dooku Asajj went down 10 points.
Yep, and that's a spooky list. That is a
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
That's what Nathan played in our Shatterpoint game.
Oh, my God.
Shut the fuck
up. Wait, the triple saber. The triple saber list. Oh,
Because Grievous came down another 5 points. Grievous is at 150 now.
Maul Asajj.
So,
Dooku,
I mean,
Grievous.
If I did Dooku, Grievous, you could do Dooku, Grievous, and Ventress, and I'm still at 500 points. And because it's all, I mean, that's 3 activations.
Ben, stop talking.
Let me go.
Ben, droids are over. Next. Shut up. Steve, I know you're listening. Stop listening, Steve. Steve, stop listening from Rochester. Stop listening to this right now.
Use it to Tim.
Listen, and Grievous's gun is now free. Free. That gun.
I mean,
is
it should just be on his profile,
weapon, and it was always an auto include for me. Yeah, it probably should be. But it's such a good gun. So now it's free. So still 155 points. I mean, it just gets better and better. I mean, Droidicas came down 5 points. So now it's actually really got me looking at Droidicas because they're now at 70, which puts them slightly cheaper than Staps, and about the same price as Spider Droids.
Yeah.
And forgot how many shields they have. It's tough.
They have all. They are That's hard true. To bring down if you don't commit to them.
Yeah, if you don't have a lightsaber or something. Yep.
Yeah, if you pummel them and you put a whole turns where the shooting, they'll crumple.
Right.
But also they block line of sight now.
Yeah.
And the neat thing that I don't think people have really taken advantage of yet is I think off the top of my head, they're the only multi-unit ground vehicle unit
so far.
Which
speeders
which,
block more space?
Imperial speeders.
No, they're not ground speeders. They're not ground vehicles.
You're right.
And so, like normally with an AT-RT, when you're moving it around as kind of like a mobile barricade, you have a very fixed movement template and a fixed line that you have to stay behind. Now with cohesion, you can use that second droid to put them exactly where you need them to block the line of sight on your Dooku or your Ventress or your snipers or whoever it is you're trying to protect. And I think there's real value there.
I really do.
I think that's fair.
The problem, of course, is going to be suppressive. Suppressive is a thing keyword doesn't do a whole lot right now.
It does if you bring a ton of them.
Yeah, it does if you bring a bunch of them. Yeah. And they're all 5 points,
Even 2 of them, honestly.
Yeah.
But for the point cost now of 70, I mean, it used to be 100.
That's crazy.
Now. It's a really... Yeah.
I forgot
they're cool, too.
I forgot they were 100.
There's a rule of... There's a rule cool for me for them, too, because they're just neat to see on the table. It's a cool-looking unit.
The ball form, going speed 3 around, they're fun.
Yeah, it's cool. People have those cool shields.
If you've got the right objectives, I mean, I've won. Like, I have won using wheel mode and be like, GTFO, guys, woo! Well,
yeah,
and just
bombing run wheel
forget,
mode.
Like, thank you. Yeah, so I was going to say, like, you can use them for bombing run. Like, just...
How do they hold it? I don't know.
attach it. Tucker bomb.
They got a tow cable on it.
I was surprised to see that Lonnie, the super tactical droid with no name, is now down 5 points. Because I loved him.
He's solid.
I mean, yeah. I named Lonnie.
Oh, yeah. I like him.
He's got a little bit of both of them.
To get that half blend of Kalani and Kraken, a little bit of everything, 90 points, that's a good place to be. And you get those command cards, because those command cards are incredibly good. I mean, it's all sunshines and roses over here in the Sith world, so I'm super happy for it.
And then, down into Mercenary Corner.
Yes, please, we'll do it.
Welcome to my scum and villainy.
Untouched pikes.
I'm not surprised by that.
Pikes were touched
last time.
Yeah, they were hit pretty hard last time. Once again, we have to remember, Ben hasn't played since they were hit the last time.
That's true. Listen,
I've been watching 4 points for those four. You're the one who's talking about keyword spam. Those 4 points don't make
up.
They do when you bring six of them
and then three capos.
Yeah. They're still obnoxious, but Black Sun, like in the metagame for the past 3 months, have definitely been more of a problem.
Black Sun have been the new hotness.
They have, and I've watched it on the streams. I have.
Black Sun go up as a unit from 48 points to 50 points. And the Magnet Enforcer goes up another 2 points. And don't you forget
it. Yeah, it prices out the Pink Suns, and that's about it.
Yeah.
The Magnet Enforcer is 16 points.
Well, he was 14.
Black Sun should have gone up 2 more points. 2 more points is what I'm saying.
I think they may get touched up another bit, but... I think they're also trying to not make them useless because you go too far and then suddenly it's a useless range 2 unit.
Right. So, it is a cool unit. So yeah.
For 28 points, I can throw a bomb from a BX droid that has 1 black and 2 white.
Well, that's why your faction's bad. Moving on. Imperial Boba Fett has gone up 10 points.
As he should.
As he should, yeah.
Yes. With all his new Boba command cards, they've just been stupid.
Yeah. His command cards.
I kind of wish they were like
the top. I get it.
Shadow Collective Maul, where they specified which Boba could use them, but that is what it is.
Sure.
And then,
would it be?
Back to the good times. Gar Saxon and Mando Super Commandos are both down 5.
Yep.
So...
They needed it.
Eric Maylot,
people weren't playing them.
Wherever you are, running your Gar Saxon and 4 Mandos, enjoy your 20-point discount. 25-point discount.
I was going to say, you start adding upgrades and things on there? Yeah. The rockets went down, too.
Yeah, rockets. That's the Rebel ones.
Oh, is it only Rebel ones?
Yeah.
It's only the Rebel ones, yeah.
The Shadow Collective ones.
I do want to say that their points cut was more than the Rebel Mandos points cut.
Was it?
No, because the upgrades only went down by 2.
True. Right.
They're down by 5. All the upgrades are by 2, so that's 6. And I think the Rebels went down 7. Okay, I digress.
I apologize. That was very not correct.
That was live on air, everyone. There you go.
That's fine.
Yes.
I don't know what's happening. There's 70 points now. Mando's
going. Yes, there you go.
Gar Saxon and Mando's down 5. Swoops, also down 5. Hello, Value Town.
Hooray. Yeah, swoops are cool. Like
65 points
for 6 wounds of white save, swooping around.
Yep, and I've been playing swoops the last little while since Worlds.
Yeah.
They are a bucket of fun, and they're not great Rebels, but I think triple swoops and mercenaries is so good.
I think bounty hunters with triple swoops, so you have a ranged attack, and then also these flankers coming around like I did at Cincinnati. It's real fun.
Yeah, for sure.
It's real fun.
Yeah, I saw them. Yeah. I did that
when you fly through a group of B1s just touch me. Taking bodies with you, it's one of the best things in Legion. and then, like I mentioned, the Super Commando generic upgrades, so not Rook, but the Gunslinger and the Marksman, who add keywords that are not Gunslinger or Marksman, they both go down 2 points.
Yep. So they're at 28 points now. So they're still not the extra body at 24, but still 28 is a much better place for those upgrades.
Yep.
Definitely.
They are.
And then Ryan mentioned the AA5 quad laser for both factions went down 3. Cool. And then for every faction,
hooray.
Force choke up 5 to 10 points.
Should have been more, enough, but okay. But
praise the Lord.
It could have been 15 and some people would still use it.
Yeah.
But here we are.
I think it should have been 15. Yeah. I'm going to be honest with you. I think we've got to increase the point cost.
There's too much mass on.
For the force allows you to use
either
it.
Either point cost or give me some errata for it.
Expend.
Right.
Yeah, yeah, just give me some clarification for it. Be like, no. You can't be doing this. Ryan, I agree with you. It should be one wound, not like take a mini or whatever.
You don't pick the mini that's applied. You pick
Because nothing else works that way.
Nothing else in the game selects a single mini.
And I understand why they would go with that approach at first, because it is they grab someone and choke them. So I understand why you think like, oh, you can choose who you grab and choke. But it's just so busted to be like, hey, that thing you paid 30 points for, boop.
Yeah.
Now I'll force push you away because you're useless in the game mostly, and I'll go attack someone else now and choke their friend.
Yeah.
Or like, and that way it's still good when you're like tied up with one wound left. You can just kill the unit and then walk away. Like, you can still do that crap, but it's the just walking up to a unit and reducing their efficiency by like a huge percentage.
And honestly, I would love to see all of the force powers gain a line of sight requirement too. I would not be mad to see that.
Well, Jedi do close
most
their
eyes. Most of them have it, don't they? Which ones
push
don't?
Does not.
These days?
No.
Oh, push doesn't still?
Yeah,
oh, still. Man.
Push doesn't. Mind trick doesn't. Choke doesn't. I think the only one that does is barrier and lift.
Saber
throw. Well, obviously saber throw.
What about guidance?
Who cares?
I don't think guidance does.
All right, two units
at range one to two.
Actually, force lift.
Yeah. Yep. Me and Mitch were.
And force lift doesn't require a line of sight either.
We're noodling around, and I do really want to try Ahsoka Op Luke double guidance, where they just like you give each other Mando saves.
Yeah, you just
guide
each other around the board.
Yeah,
it's only five points.
Yeah,
you never attack. You just guide. Just guide.
It's a
guide,
free
guide, 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 guide. Yeah. Oh, it's free. It's true.
It's a tappable free action force power. With a,
I don't think there's a lot there, but there might be something
there.
With
a bad Obi-Wan art on it. I'm sorry, artist. It looks like you photoshopped a face on him.
Yeah.
Just a little bit.
Those are the points.
Everyone.
I like the changes.
Yeah.
I think for really all the factions, it makes me excited. I'm excited to see where we're going. I think, like we talked about, there could have been a couple more tweaks and adjustments, but I think we're a big step in the right direction.
Yeah, and you can't, as much as I want them to, like, you can't do for my rebels, you can't do a points cut across the board. I get that. Or for really any of these factions.
Yeah.
It looks like they identified like Mandos and Speeders, and then the heavies and supports for Gar, and then, you know, Mandalorians for mercenaries. They just kind of picked one archetype and said, you know what, for this season, we're going to make this a little bit better. If it becomes oppressive, we'll readjust. If it's not enough, maybe they'll tweak again.
And I'm okay with small tweaks. They talked about it years ago, you know, that they want to do smaller adjustments.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm fine with that. If we stick with that, that's fine.
Yeah.
We've had two adjustments this year so far.
And
if
you count the CRB as a adjustment.
Sure.
Because the points was technically last year,
wasn't it? December.
Oh, true.
It was early December.
So still though, but yeah.
No, if they keep coming out at this regularity, that's like every 6 months. That's
yeah, fine. I'm fine with that. Every 6 months is fine.
But archetypes, I'm still not seeing. I'm still not seeing bomb throwers. I'm still not seeing mines.
Sabs.
I think there was a good sab.
There was a good rebel sab list at Rocky Top.
He means BX.
I'm not gonna lie. Yeah, well,
Oon. Yeah, but I do also mean one. I haven't seen Empire Sabs in a while.
That's
because they're too busy playing Darks and Blizzard.
They're too busy playing. I actually think Imperial Sabs are quite good.
Yeah,
especially Remnant.
But it's just other things in their faction are better.
I kind of agree with that, but also most of the time, when you see scouts out in the wild, I see them being used as objective squads.
Yep.
Not bomb squads, because Scout 3.
Yes, that's exactly how we should do it.
Because you're Scout 3, so you just go boop, 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 and that's it. And you're low profile now, and boom, boom.
I mean, that full squad for 48 points
is fantastic. And now that you can't start next to objectives with Scout anymore, maybe there's a place for them where you Scout a micrometer away, move, toss a bomb for whoever's about to chase you, and then try to double move away next turn. I don't know. I think Imperial Scouts, bomb throwers could be interesting, but dark troopers need to go away.
Yep.
Bikes need to become less popular because
there are so many options that can just fly around and nuke them.
Yeah. Yeah.
See, my hard thing with darks, and I mean, this could be a whole nother cast, but like, I agree that they're oppressive as are, and maybe these points will help. I think these points will help. Let me be clear about that. I think they will help. I don't know if they'll do all the help we need, but I think they will help in the right direction. But it's a cool unit. Like, I still want to see a unit.
Sure.
Play.
Yeah. I think everything needs its place.
Right. Right.
Just not. But everywhere.
But 20 health worth of red armor saves is not good for the game.
That's probably true. Probably true.
So 10, like that's an archetype. That's you're teching into an armor spec. Because remember when the ATSTs used to be, and to some degree because of their range, still can be relatively unkillable, and they're 11 wounds on white saves.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so, you know, you're adding an extra third to the resilience with just the better die, plus the ability to get surge tokens if you're teched that way. And almost doubling the health.
I haven't seen the ATST.
The Federation Battle Tank.
You're about to see a bunch of them because they're going to make Chewbacca noises.
Thank God Discord cut him off there.
All right.
Okay.
But it exists on the tape, Will. It exists on the tape.
Well, whenever Ryan starts making Wookiee noises, it's time we need to get off the show.
He's been doing that for years.
Thanks for listening to the STABcast. We do that in the middle of the night. Thanks for listening to us during your paint time, your drive time, your Wookiee time, your Ewok time, whatever it is you're doing out there. We appreciate you. As always, I'm Will Heim, reminding you that my ISP rockets will block out the sun.
Oh, I was waiting for Ryan.
I don't ever go. I don't know when to go right now.
I go next.
Yeah. So you go next. Because you got to skip.
I'm leaving that in.
And I'm Ryan Slowoski, remind you.
And again, you got cut off there. Mercifully for us, hopefully for the listeners as well. Yes, right. I'm Tim Hannon, reminding you to also, in addition to the other events we mentioned, look at going to Dragonflight Game Con in Seattle, August 18th to the 20th.
Tim forgot to add events that people asked him to add.
No, they actually just got added right now where we're talking.
All right, fine.
And also, cool. August 24th to the 27th is Tacticon, once again, hosted by 5280.
Yeah, so that's in Colorado.
Also, listen to...
Cutting that.
We're taking that bit out, yeah.
And I'm Ben Fowler, reminding you, check your blood sugars, guys.
Jesus Christ.
You can live to play Legion games.
This has been a two-hour PSA about diabetes.
That's right. It all comes back around.
Diabetes.
Is it like the Tooth Fairy, Ben? Did you put your toe underneath your pillow, and did you get an early retirement fund? Is that how this works?
I will say... I did drop like 10 pounds while
there
I was in
go.
The hospital.
That's and a
I was
heavy like, toe.
Oh, look, did my big toe 10 pounds?
Boo-doo-boo, we're waiting on Ben to hit the goddamn button.
I've been living the last 2 weeks in mountain time.
I have pressed the button to record. Are we
it
ready
is a time on? Zone. It's
I'm
not recording. Just for Mormons.
It's Mormon
I'm
time.
I'm counting us in.
Mormon daylight time.
Two, one.